Only 37 degrees.
So you were disqualified for being actually three people in a trench coat.
Yes.
You actually tried to Little Rascal your way through the decathlon.
I was part of that Jamaican bobsled.
You were the Yes, that's right. You were the third guy. Like, because no one really based. Everyone knows the fourth. Oh, you were the fourth.
It's embarrassing.
No, this is amazing.
Oh, wow.
So,
no, this is live. This is all happening. So I think it's important. Do we have like a third camera that can show the fact that all of the technology here has just been taken over by not members of the team? And in fact, everyone who normally does Juno TV is off eating right now.
Yep.
And the inmates have taken over the asylum.
Hey, the inmates are here.
I'm going to.
The inmates are here.
They're running and hot.
So when you came and sat down. Were you hoping to have a piece of this sandwich? Is that
can
sort
you,
of what
can you see a sandwich? Can we focus in on this sandwich?
So, you know,
that was on the ground. And
you want that?
Oh, he's got it.
I was going to finish that. It's very heartbreaking.
I thought you were offering it to me, and he just.
No, I know. That was quite rude.
Fair enough.
So you guys are here kind of specifically just because you don't want to go to your seats in the nosebleeds right
Absolutely.
Now, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. You don't want to see the Alyssa Cara opening right now?
Who is that?
Alyssa Cara. She's singing. She's opening.
Oh, she sounds fantastic.
Yeah, you can hear the muffled sounds.
I can see it.
I'm going to ask a sincere question. How's your Juno weekend been?
It's been fantastic.
It's been good?
Oh, hello.
It's been brutal.
Well, no sleep plus...
It's a rating system on this show.
In terms of like...
In terms of how young are the people listening?
Well, I mean, I would say...
Should I put my address out? Postal code included?
123 Fake Street.
Give your SIN number for sure. I think people want to know... How they can like register a credit card in your name.
You guys want to know something crazy about the music industry?
Are you going to tell truths right now?
Spitting hot fire like okay. Dylon. This is called a microphone condom. Check it out.
I mean,
huh?
They're back.
Smoke and mirrors,
safer,
man. Smoke and mirrors.
All smoke and mirrors.
On.
Kevin.
I don't think that's necessarily like a hot secret.
Kevin.
Okay.
What?
Kevin. I mean, people know. Oh, okay. Yeah.
The actual person.
This is live, right?
Okay. And now we're also joined by Kevin Chaos. I love this. Is this
that's
so?
That's his last name. Yes.
Kevin Chaos.
Kevin Chaos. Kevin Os is what we call him in the show.
So I kept wondering if this was like a vape, but it's not a vape. Is it just 100% a prop?
No,
it's crack.
It's something we can't talk about on television.
We're on the internet.
Okay.
Oh, we're talking about everyone.
Oh yeah.
Show us your dick.
Show us your dick. Show us your dick. Show us your dick.
We've been.
Don't do it.
We've been live for. Four minutes before
you said it was internet. You said it was internet. Everything.
We got five people.
We got Tetris.
This is bullshit. You said it was internet. You said it was internet.
I can say for sure. So we have a chat actually going. So you can see that there is a chat happening. So there are people watching the event. Real. I want to cry. Sean
Mendes.
Oh,
hey, Haley from Regina.
If you're chatting back, you'd actually be chatting as one of our guys.
Punkdick.com?
Yeah, punkdick.com is there.
Hello, my love.
Guys, thank you for joining us off the top for this amazing opening on the show.
Guess what?
Oh.
We
enjoy your
well, see you later.
Are you going to try to sell those seats like up at the top? Oh. See, you know what the problem with that was is you were...
Where's the nearest jackass?
You were making the fart sound with your mouth but pointing the mic at your butt so no one heard it. No. That's showbiz magic. Thank you, guys. So as you can see, the whole point of having this backstage is to provide you with the most professional possible window into the Junos, into the serious way that people approach their time here. And I'm joined now by Mike Tompkins, my co-host for the last 2 days. Mike, how are you doing?
I'm doing so good.
Yeah, that was a strong opening.
I was watching from the side.
Yeah.
I didn't really know what to do.
That was a tough one. So, I mean,
I got a little uncomfortable when. Well,
it was just one of those
things.
There
was actually multiple moments.
They were sort of operating all of the cameras And then all of a sudden, you guys were like, we're going to go live. And I was like, we don't want to deal with this for a second. And I was just left hung out to dry there for about 5 minutes. And then Jill started going, wrap it up. And I was like, I didn't start this.
This hasn't started yet.
This is not on me.
So what happened was, we were just doing this as a joke.
No.
I didn't realize we were actually live until I went back over there. And they're like, I was like, wait, we're not actually live, are we?
Yeah, no, that was all live. So again, I'm not quite sure who to blame for that, but I'll pick one of you guys later. I see a lot of stuff going on in the chat. People are extremely excited.
Somebody from Brazil saying, go Sean.
People are extremely excited about Sean Mendes. So as a heads up, for those of you that seem, there's a few people a little confused. This, what you are watching right now, is Mike and I. It's our friend Mandy over there at Bad Portraits on Twitter.
Hello, guys.
And we are backstage. We can hear the sound of the show. And we're going to be interviewing the performers, the presenters, the winners at tonight's show. The actual show itself is on CTV. I believe if you are a subscriber to a cable package, you can use the CTV Go app.
Or if you have bunny ears,
I'm sure. Actually, yeah, CTV for sure comes in over the air if you have bunny ears. Or if you have the internet. You probably can find it, guys. Like, come on. It's 2016.
It's 2016.
Like, just get it together. So, yeah. A lot. Actual show, et cetera, et cetera. This is not it. I mean, this is an actual
show. Yesterday was fun.
Show.
We're gonna have more fun tonight. Tonight's the night where we have more fun.
I think we're going to have, like, last night was sort of like warm-up fun.
It was really a warm-up last night.
So, for people who are just tuning in tonight, who weren't here last night, the Juno Awards, of which this is the 45th year, award the vast majority of the awards on the Saturday night as part of a big gala. There's a fantastic dinner. There's some performances Sunreal played last night. A few other artists, a few other great artists. So 36 awards were handed out last night, and I believe seven awards are handed out tonight, including Fan Choice Award, Single of the Year. A lot of the big marquee awards all get handed out tonight. And there's a big show happening in the Saddle Dome, which we are in just around the corner.
And we are going to talk to many people.
We're going to talk to many people. I see a lot of people screaming about Sean Mendes in this chat. I feel like this chat is almost entirely Sean Mendes fans. And I just want you to know that I met Sean Mendes earlier on the red carpet.
Yeah.
Sean Mendes is a nice dude.
Yeah.
What a nice guy. Have you guys like worked together?
I've never met him.
You've never met Sean Mendes? No. You guys seem like you potentially like, I mean, I know it's like
Vine
is not the same, but it's like you guys seem like you maybe could
internet function. Friends.
Yeah, exactly.
We're all internet friends.
We are all internet friends, let's be honest. Yeah. But hopefully, you know, maybe we can get him back here and you guys can get a chance to ask Sean a couple of questions. But yeah, last night, Mike and I were here, or in a convention center, but on the same set, so it felt the same.
Yeah, except it was the way.
Yeah, I'm used to, I was here, and then
Mandy was over there.
Yeah, it was a bit different.
Now you're over there.
But this
and
is
if you guys didn't tune in last night, should we explain what Mandy does?
Please, yeah, please.
Mandy, at Bad Portraits on Twitter, makes bad portraits, but they're not bad.
Well, thank you so much.
The cool irony is
that was
the
last night, though. That
could have
been a fluke, you guys. That could have been.
I don't think it was.
You know, we just
met. I already
met.
See you starting,
I was really excited.
And I'm already liking what's going on over there. Can you show us anything that you did last night?
I might be able to show you a couple things. Let me see what I can find.
Yes.
I remember this. We tried to get fed.
Yes.
This is the wonderful Roger Mooking.
Oh, Roger Mooking. Yeah, so Mooking. Roger Mooking from Bass's Bass, and the chef for last night's dinner.
Right.
There's a great. I'm realizing now, like, I don't think there's a camera on you.
No, I don't think so either. So I'll show you guys.
There's a camera on you.
No.
I'm sorry.
I just sort of am used to just sort of acknowledging it. But here, we can.
Yeah, I'll just pass to you. I can.
Yoink.
I should have practiced airplanes.
So this was Mandy's amazing portrait of, Roger Mooking, who.
Oh my God! That's terrifying.
That's the future.
So I shouldn't be texting at all.
Don't text. Yeah, be careful.
Just kidding. I would never do that.
And so yeah, Mandy's been doing these of all of the winners that have come back to talk to us.
Pretty amazing.
Oh.
They're extremely great. In addition to that, we're live on Facebook, and we are live on other platforms that are not sponsoring us.
Thank you.
People who are sponsoring us though include the OMDC, who are great, and Google Play Music. And all the performances from tonight's show are going to be available streaming on Google Play.
What are these?
Those are oil-absorbing sheets to keep me from looking like a shiny, sweaty mess.
Is it helping me yet?
You look way better. Honestly, you look so, so much better. It's a dramatic improvement.
You can't see your reflection in my face?
Yeah, no, it's different now. I'm gonna dab down.
Oh, my goodness!
Yeah.
Oh!
We should have, like, a garbage, because these are just going to collect.
Thank you.
Mandy, do you have any... Oh, hold on, I'm not done. Mandy, now that we know that there's a camera above you, can you sort of show that camera the portraits that you made of Mike and I also? Are they still there, or are they...
I think I lost Mike's. I don't know.
There was two
but I'll
of them.
Show you yours.
Okay, yeah. Show the camera mine. Just to give you an idea of some of the stuff that we've been doing for all the artists here.
Let's see what. Oh, this is the Swinging Bells.
Oh, yeah. So this was Swinging Bells, who won for Children's Recording of the Year last night.
Can't feel my face.
Oh, yeah. That's The Weeknd.
Abel.
This is another one I didn't show you with Mike, but it's not very good. This is...
Oh, that was Cataclysm.
Yeah.
So that was Cataclysm who won hard/metal.
I love
album
their name.
It's a great name.
Fun to say.
It's a great band.
Yeah, I'm gonna go grab this for a moment.
Yeah,
just check it. Oh,
we don't need that plug-in. We're good.
John Montgomery.
Oh, John Montgomery. Hello.
Who's our host, everybody?
You know, I gotta say. So we were out there. We were doing the red carpet. I was out there for it was a better part of 2 hours, and I was overwhelmed by how tall everyone was. Every successful Canadian musician. Oh.
Justin Bieber. Oh, they keep talking.
No, Bieber. Show them Justin Bieber, yeah. So there we got Justin Bieber. Beautiful, nominated tonight. I was overwhelmed by how tall seemingly everyone who is a successful Canadian musician is. Nickelback, all giants. Paul Brandt, so tall. Jim Cuddy, tall. Literally, just every single one of them is tall. And then...
I am not tall.
No, you and I are the same height. So that's good. And then there was some... I started this because I was excited. Oh, yeah. And then John Montgomery, who's an athlete, and really the tallest profession, he and I are, like, the same height. And that made me feel a lot better. So John Montgomery, very good for my ego, which is great. Speaking of people who are about our height, we have Gunnar Rola here. Come on in. Come on, hang out, man.
What's up? What's up?
Yeah. What a surprise.
Wow.
There
you go, man.
Hi.
Wow. So many people from Brazil tuning in here.
Yes. Which camera do I look into?
This
on?
One.
Leave your
this
comments,
one.
Okay, everyone.
Yeah. So, how's it going, man?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank
Hi,
you.
Hi, Mike. We're meeting for
hey.
The first time on
you
camera.
You guys don't know each other?
Exclusive.
Great to see you.
Thank you.
Again,
nice
I just assume
too.
People who, like, make music on the internet are potentially sort of all friends.
Yeah.
But that's not true.
We're friendly.
We're friends.
Oh, we're
okay.
friends now.
You guys don't have, like, beef or anything. There's not, like, secret.
No beef.
Not yet.
No.
Are there YouTubers
yeah.
that
Maybe
you
after
guys,
this interview.
that you guys do beef with?
Oh, geez. We're going to jump right into that.
Yeah, man. It's backstage. Like, if people want
no.
the yeah. flashy show, they can turn on CTV or log into their CTV Go app. But... We're out here to offer people
the
real
juicy details.
Yeah.
Is that what this is?
I think
sorry. I've got another appointment.
You've actually been ambushed.
I think there may be one person that I have a beef with.
Yeah.
But they probably don't know I have a beef with
But
them.
Who is it?
I'm not going to tell you.
Why not?
Because I'm not going to do that. I'm not going
to
do that.
But we're trying to make...
I'm not going
to
do that.
We're trying to, like, make the guest comfortable. And so I think it's like, you know, you show me yours, I'll show you mine kind of thing. I think...
Well, his first name's Sam.
Yeah, and?
How do you say his last name again?
Is it Sutherland with no vowels?
With no vowels.
Yeah, no. God damn. I knew it. Okay, I knew. Well, I'm glad that we are airing out our grievances here live at junotv.ca.
Lovely.
So now that he has told his secret,
Sam, yes.
What about you?
I have no beef with anyone.
Mm.
Not currently. Not. I'm coming into 2016, is that the year?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're into
no
yeah.
beefs.
We're kind of deep in 2016 at this point, man. It's April.
Yeah,
I've been in a deep slumber.
We are not entering the year.
It's all right.
Yeah.
No beef.
Okay,
no.
That's good.
Canadians are nice.
I would say this. This is my hot take.
Okay.
I don't think Canadians are nice, but I think that we are afraid of offending each other.
True.
So I think in private we're quite cruel.
Right.
But I think very none catty. Of us would ever say anything mean about anyone into a microphone. On
definitely
like,
not on a live broadcast.
Yeah, yeah.
I have absolutely no beef with anybody. I just want to put that out there too.
I have beef,
no
beef with everyone.
behind doors.
Oh yeah, secret beef, which secret is beef. The name of my dance music project.
That's so good.
We're terrible, though. Oh, my God. We're so bad. Oh, so Walk Off the Earth just won Group of the Year.
Oh, yay, my.
Congratulations
gosh,
to them, guys.
That is awesome.
That is great.
That is amazing.
We interviewed them earlier. There was at least two babies with them. It was. I don't know if are the babies in the group now. Does anyone know?
Are they playing music?
Are the babies official members?
I got an autograph. I tried to get an autograph for one.
Do you collect autographs?
I mean.
What are you, eight?
Yes, I am. I just aged very terribly.
Yeah. No, wait. Did you actually get an autograph?
No, I didn't.
Okay.
I didn't. No. You know what, though? I am excited. Just on topic of YouTube, Just Rain is here. Love
yeah,
Just Rain.
Yeah.
So I got to chat with him. That was cool.
Do you guys think of, so I mean, like, you guys are obviously extremely active on the tubes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Walk Off the Earth is a band that on some level kind of got their start in that space.
Well, they definitely did.
Yeah, like, so do you guys as sort of like, you know, very active tubers, think of them as like a sort of like YouTube act, or are they sort of more of a an artist that is sort of used it as kind of part of their platform? You know what I'm saying?
Every sense, like, every artist in their sense, like, any YouTuber is using YouTube as a platform to
right.
display their whatever it may be. And so I think they're a great example of somebody who's...
Yeah, the potential of yeah. what you can do with that. So.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it's pretty cool to see their career
yeah.
and see how it's like they've been able to use YouTube as a platform. And a really, obviously, the really big moment in their career was like Gautier
yeah.
Cover that they did. They blew up that song.
Yeah.
Like, that song nobody knew about until they covered it.
Yeah, I heard it first as a cover from them, too.
And then that song became the biggest song of that year, which is crazy.
Yeah.
That's such an amazing story, and that was such a revolutionizing time in music because that had never happened before.
Yeah, for sure.
That I know of.
Did that sort of change the way that you guys were approaching like what you were doing on YouTube at all? Like, knowing that, like, I don't know, that was like a possible...
It didn't change the way I was doing things. It was
yeah.
just, like, I mean, I think we were all trying to achieve the same thing.
Yeah.
And just, you know, to have a career in music and to not work at, you know, a coffee shop.
Be true to yourself. I think covers
actually,
are a great way to kind of, you know, get noticed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's a good thing.
Okay, so, like, dialing it back, but then trying to be more positive on, like, the beef conversation. Who are you, like, secretly, like, enamored of? Like, who are you, like...
In the YouTube space or just in Canadian music?
In Canadian music space. Could be like a YouTuber, could be just, you know, like a
I just saw Alessia Cara perform. Love
yeah.
her.
How was that?
Amazing.
We were back and we could hear it. It sounded good.
Like hear it from the stage?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay,
no, so. You could sort of like through the wall. Like she was a noisy neighbor.
I probably not the best representation of the experience to listen to it that way, but it was
okay,
a really
yeah.
good really good performance. I love Carly Rae Jepsen. Is she here?
Yeah. I don't know. I didn't see her. She wasn't walking the red carpet, so I don't know.
Okay.
To be honest, like that album got dissed, right? Like it's not nominated.
I know, but it had so much critical acclaim.
I know.
Did you enjoy
it?
I loved it.
I,
yeah.
I
loved
really, really like both of you guys. I just want to say that.
Yeah.
I really, 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 really like you guys.
Did you say the right number of reallys?
I really, 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 really,
really, really, really like you. Thank you. Oh man, that's a tune.
That's
catchy.
Huge,
so good.
That whole album's
tune.
Full of pop jams.
Yeah.
Right. So
I kind of feel like.
Damn.
This was like the recalibration of like the Carly Rae thing. Like I remember reading a Scooter Braun interview where he was talking about how like on the last record it was like they had the biggest single, like this monumental song, biggest song of the year, but like no one really heard the record. And so the goal on this was to kind of make like the credibility pop record, and then it kind of didn't matter. Like so now she can go and it's like now she can go and put out like a huge, huge pop record again and like
sorry. No, I didn't want to interrupt this. What you were
no,
saying is very important.
The chat.
I don't
know
why I had to put your computer down all of a sudden. Sorry.
I'm done with this.
This is my first time doing. Can we switch?
Yeah.
There we go.
Tight. But yeah, now she can do kind of whatever she wants.
Yeah.
And like, and people have like sort of maybe recalibrated their opinion of her or whatever, right?
Well,
maybe.
Yeah, it's a great album nonetheless. Hopefully
yeah.
the next one gets a lot of commercial attention as well.
Congratulations to Carly Rae Jepsen for making
a great album.
I know, it's good. It's very positive.
So Buffy St. Marie is performing right now, though.
Yo, guys, I have now, so we got to the point where, like, today on the red carpet, Buffy St. Marie was like, oh, hey, Sam, nice to see you again. And I was like,
dead.
And now my ghost is hosting Backstage for Juno TV. Thanks to the OMDC for sponsoring me. Things have not recovered since those monsters started the stream, guys.
How many hours have you clocked, like, talking?
Talking at this point, 4 hours. 4 hours yesterday, two hours on the red carpet. This is going to be like two and a half hours. And we did interviews at the end of the day. It'll ultimately have been like a full work day of only talking. Right.
Are you getting a little hoarse? Do you have any special techniques?
Oh. Yeah, it's, I know. You know, I blame the dry.
It's very
so dry
in Calgary. Love like, Calgary. It's
very
dry.
I actually have chapstick on me like,
I'm
right
so
now.
Jealous because of your chapstick.
You can borrow some, man. Somebody's asking, did Alicia Cars perform already? Yes.
She did.
No,
she opened the show.
Cars. Yeah. People are so excited about Shawn Mendes. Like, I get it, but, like, I don't know that I've ever loved anything like the way that the people in this chat love Shawn Mendes.
Even on the red carpet.
For those
too.
Who want to watch online, they can go watch the broadcast on CTV Go app.
That's good info. It's crucial info for the people.
See you guys.
What was your actual favorite Canadian record of last year? Do you have, like, any sort of, like...
Did Sugar Jones release their album last year?
I don't know.
No.
I can Google that right now.
Okay.
Sugar Jones album.
Yeah, wasn't that last year? No.
Sugar Jones. No, that was 2011.
Okay.
With Sugar
I
Jones.
I told you I was in
Which
a deep
one was
deep
Sugar?
Slumber. Wasn't paying attention. Pop
oh
stars, the Canadian okay. pop stars.
So we're discovering, so we made a joke, like yesterday we were interviewing Alan Reed, who's the president of Keras, the organization that runs the Junos, and he came and sat down, and because our default last time we were talking was we were interviewing winners, so we'd be like, congratulations on your Juno win, and blah, blah, blah. So he came and sat down, and I was like, congrats on your Juno win, like it was a joke, and he was like, I don't know if you know this, but 10 years ago I actually won a Juno. I was like, oh, because I don't know Alan Reed's like entire history or whatever. Oh, they just announced Single of the Year. And I think I know
who.
I heard it. I wonder what the delay is. Like, can we spoil the Junos for people? Like, are we on a tighter schedule? Anyway, so The Weeknd just won Single of the Year, guys.
Awesome.
Ooh, I can hear it. Song is so good.
Very moody.
So Alan Reed, like I said, runs the Junos, was like, no, I want a Juno for the Tragically Hip, I think, Greatest Hits Collection or whatever.
This might actually be a good opportunity for me to bring up that I'm launching a new venture.
Oh, yeah, this is a great opportunity to
There's a Juno for Record of the Year, mm-hmm. but there's no Juno for Recorder of the Year. So I brought a recorder with me.
Oh, okay.
And if it's okay, I'd like to play a sample.
I think it would be great if you would. So this is what you're going to sort
I
of.
Join this,
Let's
yeah,
see.
Yeah, no, please.
Can you recognize this tune?
Okay. I believe that's the Single of the Year winner, The Weeknd, played on
Very
the recorder.
Timely. Very timely.
Okay, wait, what else can you do?
Let's try to.
I believe that's the boy, Jay Biebs. Yeah?
Yeah, that's the boy.
That's all I'll do because I don't want to pay too much in royalties.
Oh,
but,
yeah, actually.
Yeah.
I think we've actually just cost Karis. Like tons
Sorry, so
of
can,
money.
So can.
Yeah. Yeah, it's fine. This is what So Can.
We get a So Can discount, I think.
I know. So Sean Hook is performing on the main show right now. A reminder, that's...
also very popular.
Yeah, yeah. People love him. Apparently, so when we were interviewing Sean Hook... Yeah, man, go for it. You know what?
No.
I'm clean,
I thought
man.
Somebody just brought me one. I was like, got
I'm
so
clean.
Excited all of a sudden.
There are people in the comments, like, seemingly mad at me. Like, we want the show. And I'm telling you... CTV or the CTV Go app. I'm not keeping
this is
the show
where you
from
watch
you.
Us and we watch and you watch us
yeah.
and we talk to other people
it's
that
like
win and perform and it's still going to be entertaining. You should still watch us but
Just
you should also
the
watch
the
show too.
Please. Like listen Savannah Warren, I'm sure you're really nice. I cannot give you the show. It's not in my
There are a lot
power.
Of all caps going on here. They're
no, that's what
riled
I'm
up.
They're screaming at me. So I want to see the event, says Robert Assis. Right. If you guys would just take off your all caps, because it's not...
There are plenty of caps.
It's not me.
Why are there so many caps?
Like, literally, because I was like, you should watch it. This guy just yells, we effing can't at me.
We can't.
So, okay. There is an app. The CTV Go app. But if you can't use that app, guys, like,
just like search for a stream or something. Like,
just search,
guys,
for it online. This is 2016.
Use the internet. Like,
just Google.
I predict that it's there.
Or Yahoo. Or Bing. Or any of those search devices.
Like, turn on incognito on your thing, and then just like,
you can find the stream.
Yeah, and then you can, that'd probably be good for you, I think, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, so recorder's your new thing.
Yeah.
What else do you have going on? You've been traveling a lot.
I've been traveling a ton. We've been meaning to get
together. Yeah, yeah. Let's do a collaboration. And you're like, I am in Brazil forever now.
You're in Brazil? No.
Oh.
Clearly didn't read that email very clearly.
I have
I'm in town with Tourism Calgary, so we've been exploring the city. Love Calgary.
It's a beautiful town. It really is. We got to say props to Calgary and Tourism Calgary, who's been a great host for a lot of people that are here. Like, I can see, like, right through the gap here in the window, there's a guy there in a toque, red beard.
Right.
Yeah, that's one of my best friends, Aaron.
Okay.
He got flown out by Tourism Calgary, too.
They're good people.
He's the editor of Complex Canada.
Okay,
he's clearly tweeting up a storm right now.
Like,
he's hard at his job.
He's working hard.
Yeah. If you guys are watching, you should tweet at Aaron Zorgel. Let him know that we're talking about him and how hard he's working, and that he's doing a good job.
Right.
So Tourism Calgary.
Checking out some restaurants.
What's the best thing that you've done here that's not Juno related?
We got to give a shout out to restaurant Shikonin. Went there last night. Yeah. It's like local Japanese, so very aggressively local.
Yeah.
But we met with so many cool business owners. I think if you have a good idea and you want to get it done, come to Calgary, because people will help you out. You'll have mentors, and it's just like everything's possible here. I love that spirit.
What's been, you really have been traveling like a ton though, right?
All over the place.
So what's been, I mean, this is maybe unfair, but like, what's actually been like your favorite place you've been over the last, like, you know, year plus of globetrotting?
Right here, right now.
Oh, good answer.
Yes.
Good answer. Very present.
Very present. No, I mean, I love everywhere we go. I think it's just about trying to live in the moment and just, you know, taking a step back and being like Calgary is cool.
Yeah.
Hong Kong is cool. Singapore is cool.
But one of them's cool.
Well, I mean, you know, I'm partial to a lot of parts of Asia because they got the good food.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that sounds pretty nice. Now, are you done for a minute? Like, are you going to sort of like,
after this,
your
I'm heading out
again?
To California.
Okay, yes. Yeah, so
I'm living like a couple days at a time.
Yeah.
So after that, I don't know. I would love to travel Canada more. Our dollar's really not that great.
Yeah, so maybe you need to like
got to stick to like our the same
minute.
Continent. Mm-hmm. But yeah, beyond that, I don't know. I'm just kind of doing my own thing and taking things as they come.
Awesome. Now, I mean, like, we know we don't have to remind anyone, you know, the Junos being, you know, a celebration of the best in Canadian music. I grew up in Toronto. I don't know. Did you grow up? London, Ontario. There we go. Mike grew up like outside
Ilderton?
Of London. Ilderton? Yeah.
Was it Ilderton?
I think.
No.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Ilderton. Correct.
We could have Ilderton. Neighbors, maybe. I don't know.
Wait, so you said you're from London?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Did you come to our malls?
Walmarts? Yeah. Well, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Masonville Mall. Shout out to
Masonville
Mall.
Was Masonville Mall like the hot mall?
I was the mall for more the affluent clientele.
Oh.
North Enders.
I was a White Oaks.
Richie Rich over here.
North Enders.
Going to the good mall in London, Ontario.
North Enders.
Masonville's a good mall, though.
What was like the people's mall?
I would say White Oaks.
White Oaks is
White Oaks
right?
was the hardworking.
White Oaks, the South Enders.
That's tough. What was the, like, because, okay, when I grew up, I was in Etobicoke, and the mall near
sorry.
Us was, no, Etobicoke hey, rules, shout out to Etobicoke, and the mall was Cloverdale Mall,
okay.
That was close to me. Sherway, obviously, everyone knows, is the sickest mall in Etobicoke.
It's amazing.
But Cloverdale was closer and dominated by shoe stores for old people. But
they have a Zellers, too?
They had a Zellers.
Okay.
They did have a Zellers. In fact, one time I went, I don't think I went there, but I was in the mall when, what's like the wacky one from NSYNC, like with the crazy like with
Chris.
The Chris Kirkpatrick. Chris Kirkpatrick was launching his clothing line at Cloverdale Mall.
Wow.
This was like maybe only a year after NSYNC broke up. Like this was
that's a big deal.
Tough times. And it was called, does anyone remember what Chris
it was Fu Man something something, wasn't it?
Fu Man. I thought it was like funky. It was
or
like
maybe funky.
Fu Man funky. I don't know. If anyone knows, if anyone remembers what Chris
let us know.
Thing was called, please let me know in one of these chats. Yeah, I don't, okay, I'm not seeing it. I'm not seeing it on Facebook. Anyway,
I
so
can Google it.
In Cloverdale Mall, there was like the only record store that was in there was called Tracks with two X's, and had like an old timey jukebox front, and it was not great. That was like gonna lead into a question about crappy malls and their record stores, but apparently your portrait's ready.
Holy moly! Oh,
that one's good.
I did not know this was happening.
So. Mandy has been doing these
beautiful
for all of the winners, everyone we've been talking
to.
Thank you. Hold that up.
I love it.
She is at like Bad Portraits on Twitter. That is good.
Thanks, guys.
Worried.
You look like pensive for sure.
It says Nicole Arbor there for some reason. What's?
Oh, I guess she's here.
Oh.
So anyway, that's a drawing of you, which is
thank
amazing.
You so
painting.
Much.
You're so welcome. Painting. Yeah, painting. Drawing then painting, so it's fine. Yeah. You're fine.
Would you say you draw a painting or you paint a painting? Like, it's not, the word draw doesn't enter into the.
No, but it has tonight. So it will, can love it.
I just can't get it out of my brain, and I'm sorry.
No, it's totally fine.
Thank you.
Gonna roll
can I stick around to see Nicole?
YouTube? Yeah.
Yeah.
Where is she?
Join the party.
I don't know. I mean, her name came up.
She's coming up soon. Okay.
So
she and I go way back.
Yeah, are you
we
guys
should have
pals?
A little reunion on this like live stream.
Oh, really? You think it's a good idea?
Definitely.
Okay, cool. Then hang out for a second.
Okay.
So while we'll just get her to come in and join while you are here, which is probably good.
And then I'll hand over the
I'm going to go back to comment looking at.
Okay, so what was the, in White Oaks Mall, what was the.
Oh, we're going to go back to malls?
Well, I just.
I'll stay for that.
I wanted that story to have a point, which was like, what was the crappy record store in the Rich Mall and the People's Mall? The White Oaks and Mason, whatever.
Well, there was no crappy record store at Maysville Mall.
Oh, no.
No. I mean, they had HMV.
We had an HMV, too, White Oaks.
HMV? Okay.
Cinema
that's
One.
However, I worked at that mall for almost 3 years.
Where'd you work?
I worked at a store called Walter's Music. We sold music.
Did you
things.
Teach, too?
No, I didn't teach. It wasn't that good. I worked in the mall, and I was I look back on those times, and they were very fun. I'm thankful for those times.
Yeah, I worked at the Music World at Sherway.
I was a music teacher. We've all got a music connection here for Yamaha. What? Yeah.
This is why we're here hosting backstage at the Junos.
And it all comes full circle.
I
knew this, didn't you?
Oh, okay, I couldn't tell. Okay, just throw her in when she's around. So wait, you were a music teacher?
I was a music teacher for Yamaha.
Oh, was that in the mall too, or was that separate from the mall?
No, freestanding building.
Yeah, it's funny. We were talking earlier on the red carpet to Lights, who was here with a woman named Sam. I forget her last name, but the first name was like, easy for me to remember. And she's doing all kinds of work right now with Music Counts, which
right.
is obviously the Karis charity. The sort of responsible for putting tons of money into music education programs, and so Lights has sort of made this her whole thing. She's helping raise she's already raised like tens of thousands of dollars for Music Counts, and is now part of a big TD contribution that's like over $1 million to that. Did either of you guys have like music teachers growing up that were like super
inspirational?
Important to you?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Who was your important music teacher?
Suzanne Walker. Hello, if you're watching.
Shout out Suzanne Walker. What school or what like?
Yamaha Music School in London.
School.
Yeah,
okay.
She was an amazing teacher, amazing mentor, and I went on to teach for her as well. So it was great. Yeah.
Awesome. What about you?
Mine was a guy named Ken Fleet.
Shout out to Ken Fleet.
Mr. Fleet was a genius, wild man. that was an amazing choral director, and I mean, because I make vocal noises and you make music with just my voice.
Yeah,
he was obviously a very, influential and kind of believed in me. Kind of early, probably before I ever believed in myself, in a sense.
Yeah.
Looking back, I didn't know that at the time, but it's pretty cool to think about.
It's important, for sure. Mine was, I just want to make sure, shout outs, Les Dobbin, worked at John G. Altos and was the director of the Etobicoke Youth Band. Great band. We ripped, played all the classics like Shenandoah.
Yeah.
shout outs, Shenandoah, Lord of the Dance, all the hits. The Tempest. What was that? Did you guys play like band at all? This is my impression of band because I play drums.
I was in choir.
Yeah, I get, well, okay, yeah.
Should we duet with the recorder?
Oh, yeah. Get the recorder out and let's. Could
we're going to duet right now.
Yeah, okay, so.
Ave Maria.
Do Ave Maria, please.
Ha ha ha!
That was great.
How was that?
Started
no,
out
did
a
I
lie.
Pass the test?
That was good.
No? Okay.
I got to say, I can see why we're all so successful. It's extremely obvious to me now, you know, where this is coming
That's
from.
Great.
For sure.
That's great.
Now, do you just, like, roll with the recorder? Is that, like, your
It's something
your
that I picked up and I realized I would never, ever be good at, no yeah. matter how hard I tried. And so I just decided to embrace it.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's great. But it, like, goes in your bag. Like, you obviously travel with
Definitely.
It, right?
Get a lot of weird looks when I pass through customs, but that's okay.
Yeah, they're like, are you like a like
Travel,
an 8-year-old
yeah.
child or whatever?
Are you learning the recorder?
I gotta say.
Because nobody's ever playing the recorder. They're always learning the recorder.
That's
you
true.
Know what I mean?
That's true. You kind of learn it and then you put it away.
Yeah. Yeah. Is Nicole
I'm a student
red?
Of life.
Just throw her in. I could, yeah, okay. And we can, like, honestly, I think that I can't even, like, look at these comments because it's just people screaming at us about Sean. Oh, Shuttle Gameplays just said hello. That would be nice. Ana Luisa Memoria asked if we could bring Avril Lavigne for an interview. I will try.
We'll try.
We saw Avril walk the red carpet with Chad Kroeger. Read into that what you will. But she wouldn't do any interviews. She was just there to... CNBC.
To be continued.
I know. Are you guys Avril Lavigne fans at all?
Yeah,
yeah.
I love her stuff.
My brother's a really big fan.
Yeah?
Yeah. What? I can actually show you the text. I said I was at the Junos. He goes, say hi to Avril for me.
Oh, really? Okay,
yes.
That's good.
My friend Mark, huge fan too. So.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's, I started to tell this like extremely lengthy Avril Lavigne story during the red carpet, but then we kept getting interrupted by actual celebrities. So at some point tonight, if you want to hear a pretty good story about Avril Lavigne, I will continue it like later on in the next 2 hours. It'll be pretty good. Nicole, come on in. Come hang out.
Yay.
How's it going?
Like, what up, Roma? Can't see each other. And I'm happy to see you. Not on.
I'm going to give you this mic.
Oh, thanks, Ryan.
I'm
going
to get out of here. Oh. Right, but please, like, leave the recorder for, like, future.
Yeah, is that? That's you.
It's me.
That's awesome.
You're here.
This is
you're here.
You're
here. You're staying. You're
this
staying.
It's a lot of fun. Okay. I'm excited
yeah.
that you're here. Let's all be friends and, like, not be stupid about
yes.
life.
We just, like, loaded down the couch now with, like, YouTubers, like, from or once from Canada, apparently.
Right?
I think, yeah.
Right?
So how's your Juno weekend been so far?
So much fun. Did a party at Bespoke last night. Mother Trucking sold out. It was a crazy party.
It was a nice time.
Yeah.
And where are you partying this evening?
I will be going to the Universal and Warner parties and then back to Bespoke because Rex is hosting that party tonight, so everyone should go.
There are,
yeah.
like, honestly... so many parties happening in the city that I'm like, are there enough people in Calgary where I'm like, this is, I mean, not no offense to the
yeah.
population of Calgary, I'm just saying, it's a lot of parties.
We can party jump. Let us all do it together.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Like
Mike cheers. We're all friends now.
But not in an Uber because there are no Ubers.
No Ubers
in
Calgary.
Calgary's not a fan of, I took
yeah.
a taxi to the Juno Awards. I felt awesome. I felt old school.
Did you feel rich? When I take a taxi now, I feel like I'm deliberately making a decision
yes.
to, like, deliberately spend more money.
Yes.
Where I'm like, it's important to me that I, like, not have to talk to a man. And so I'll spend, like, $10 more to just sit on my phone and not, like, feel the need to make a joke
yeah.
to get a better rating.
Right.
Do you guys have an
I
Uber
do.
Move to, like, keep your rating up?
Well, I wear no pants. This is my thing.
I will try
can
that.
Can I swear? What is the language here?
We're on the
F
internet.
F-pants.
Yeah, okay,
F-pants
there we go.
F-pants in their air.
They told me I could. They told me I could get up to the SH word, but
what
maybe
word is that?
Not.
What
to,
word? What word is that?
Shoot.
Shoot.
Yeah.
Bang bang.
Yeah, yeah.
Mother truckers.
Yeah, but so it's like it implies yeah. violence, which is troubling for some people.
Right. Sorry about your feelings.
So what has been? There are a lot of, like, you know, Canadian musical celebrities afoot
yes.
here. Is there anyone you've been particularly excited to, like, brush up against?
Flabbergasted.
Like, I got that, like...
That's creepy. Wow, I just realized how awesome both of your glasses are. Good for
We've
you.
We've got kind of like an alternate universe.
You guys
thing.
Are like
yeah.
a Hakeem
like,
optical commercial. Come
like
to life.
Different versions.
Like,
of
like
wow.
expanding version of
you guys look
this is
great.
Good. I've always, like, wanted to, like, yeah, not be quite as... just Lily White,
what
honestly.
It's a good
Jan
look.
Arden actually complimented my glasses earlier, so
yeah.
you are now joining the esteemed ranks of also Jan Arden.
Love it.
I know.
That's amazing.
So
I've been really excited to, actually, my friends Walk Off the Earth just won, and I
yeah.
love them, and I'm so proud of them, so that's been awesome.
Yeah.
Hope to meet the weekend later.
I know, that's everyone's hope, I think.
Yeah, right? So. I just want to touch his hair.
so bad.
That's the word. Every white person just wants to touch the Weeknd's hair.
You're not supposed to do that. It's racist. Don't do it.
It's not appropriate.
Guys, thank you so much for your time. We got John Ramsey coming up next.
Holler.
Enjoy all your many parties and things.
Please.
Thank you. Can you play any like?
I overstepped.
John,
good.
We got a painting coming up. So Nicole, Mandy has been doing paintings of all of our guests. Yeah.
Should I sit? Should I watch it?
Yeah,
what am I?
If you just want to pause. No, just kidding. No, keep talking.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. Go continue to, yeah.
Quickly, posing for a photo. Yeah.
The great thing about posing when you're live on camera is that you just stop.
Isn't that weird?
No, it's good. I really.
Okay, bye everyone. Bye humans.
It's important for people to know how photos happen.
Right.
Because otherwise, it's one of life's great mysteries.
Jumping high five.
I didn't jump, I did not play along. How is that? Oh, it's looking good. So coming up next, guys.
That's looking real good.
I think so. I think they're going to, yeah, they'll grab
real good.
So I believe coming up next, we have Josh Ramsey. So if you guys, I saw some people screaming at us about Marianas earlier. So if you want your questions answered, now is the time, guys.
Ask questions.
Ask away. Don't yell at me about like where you can watch the show, but definitely yell at me about any questions you might have for Josh. Come on in, man.
Sorry,
it's fine.
That was your
How's
cue,
it going?
Man.
Better now.
Oh yeah. Now that you're not just standing awkwardly, sort of like waiting.
No, now that I'm done work for the day.
Yeah.
I've already done my TV bit. It's time to get crazy.
That is an amazing register to be able to yell at.
Wait till I get some more Jack Daniels in me. You're going to see some stuff.
Okay, yeah, that's where it's like, what's like the level where it gets like terrifying for you?
I'd say the level, there's two levels where it gets terrifying. One is if you're in a flying harness.
Oh, okay. That's just,
trust me, you don't want to
be there.
Too
much of a level, you don't want to be at that level.
The other level is another guy that that actually worked for Juno TV, Ben Nechtel. We had him at the MMVAs and I forced him to come in and interview with us. And that ended up being the beginning of the night. And by the end of the night, he woke up in the trunk of a car on Queen Street in Toronto.
That sounds dangerous. That's a dangerous story. Is he okay? Like, just to be clear.
I just saw him. He looks great.
Was he found, like, alive?
He was alive. I literally got a text message from him the next day that was like, anyways, I woke up in the trunk of a Jeep on Queen Street. I don't know whose car this is. Always good to see you, fellas.
There was one time I was staying at a hotel in like Chattanooga, Tennessee or something like that. And I had to wake up early to get some emails done. And I was just like hanging out. And there was this guy in the lobby, like on the phone, clearly to one of his buddies, just being like, man, I don't know what happened last night. No, I'm telling you, man, I was at the bar and now I'm here. And I don't know where my truck is, and I don't know who she is. Like I was like, you are a country song.
Yeah, the
like,
night took him. He was taken down. By the night.
You are a country song. I like that. We have questions coming in.
Awesome. Yeah,
I got answers.
What are the people?
Where do you buy your clothes? That's the main question.
Well, there's not really one rock star story. You know what I mean? If you find one, let me know though.
Yeah. Okay.
It's no one star. Well, okay, so where are these shoes from?
These are Jimmy Choo.
Those are great. And where are these pants from?
Gucci.
Okay, so yeah, you can't just go to one store to get all of these
things. No, they have their own stores.
Yeah. So you're like, I just buy all my things from one website on the internet, and that's like why I am not a
I don't want to tell you what I get from the websites on the internet.
You got a very different website.
Yikes. How do you pick your set list for each show?
I don't know. I just make sure the songs flow together well and hopefully keep it exciting. You know, you got to have peaks and valleys.
That was a great question, McKenna. Thanks for sending that in.
Shout out to McKenna.
Oh, McKenna. Beautiful name after a beautiful city in Hawaii.
Last question we got coming here. Are you going to dye your hair blue? I don't know.
I did that for years, and moving on.
Are there any colors that you have? Because, I mean, I feel like often when I see you, it's some new, beautiful, radiant shade. But are there any, like, no-fly zones for you? You're like, couldn't do that. Too crazy.
Don't think you're going to see me a ginger ever.
Oh, yeah.
Because I don't trust gingers. Sam, my publicist, over there, and she's a ginger.
That's an off.
But I feel like maybe next to my hair, I should just go with like plaid. Hey, there's the man himself. Get in here for an interview.
Oh, yeah.
It won't be like last time, I promise.
I think we should talk about
that.
That
was one time.
No, people,
one time
on.
You ended up in the trunk of a car. So Ben, get in here. Get in here. Come on, Ben. Come on.
He literally
come here and look into my eyes.
He's terrified of you.
I'll sing to you with the soul of a poet. Come to me.
All I can see is a
He won't do it.
Even that wouldn't bring him back.
Won't do it.
You just ruined that guy. So I really like, I got to say, because I feel the same way. I like, you know, the dyeing your hair ginger, that makes sense to me.
Yep.
Janine asked, how's the tour with Walk the Earth going? Walk off the Earth.
Sorry. Walk off the Earth. It's good. It's almost done. It's been fun. Huge shows. It's great to be back doing the arena shows here in Canada again. You know, we've been working internationally for the last sort of like year, so it's really been awesome to come home, see all of our friends, and you know, it's like coming home to family. It's great.
So they've all been good, but like, what's been the worst one?
The worst one?
Yeah, what one where you were like, this not tonight, this town.
No,
you're just not feeling it.
Well, let me tell you something. If I was a bad performer, I would answer that question. But I'm a good one, and when I'm not feeling it, you don't know. You know what I will say, though? You ever hear a song? You ever hear a song so many times that you're like, oh my God, the song makes me so crazy. If I ever hear it again, I'll punch a baby or whatever, like something crazy.
Serious violence.
Imagine if your job is to sing that song every night of the week for the rest of your life. Welcome to Showbiz, kids.
Lots of people being offended by the ginger comment.
Yeah.
Lots.
I feel like.
Yeah, but they're probably soulless goddamn gingers.
Whoa.
Oh, sorry. Were they all tweets from Ed Sheeran? Because he knows. He knows.
Terry Louise TV is very offended.
This is.
Muffin.
I think it's, you know, it's weird because I think it's sort of the one remaining, like, safe zone of, like, all of the jokes that, like, people maybe used to make about, like, inappropriate stuff, like, you know, the no-fly zones of 2016.
Right.
People just feel like they divert all of that sort of hateful, like, white guy energy into just, like, making fun of gingers.
In this
now.
One tiny freckled group.
Yeah, we're just like, it's you now. You have to pay.
You shall feel my wrath.
Yeah. So, Mandy over here has been doing a portrait of you the whole time that we've been expressing this rage.
Oh, man, I bet. I'm sure you're a lovely artist all, but I'm not a fan of the subject material.
That's rough.
You're beautiful.
That's rough. Well, mercifully, so she goes by at Bad Portraits on Twitter, so like maybe that might sort of fit more into your wheels. We've had her doing portraits of everyone kind of so far, and they're looking like, you know, they're shockingly not bad, actually.
Yeah, cool. Great.
Thanks, which, Sam. You
know. How did my hair go? I call it the weekday.
I put it down. Do you want to see a glimpse?
Oh, my God. I've never looked better. It's like an Andy Warhol. It's amazing. It's like pop art.
It is.
Who here, so like yesterday she was, you know, doing these of all the people we were interviewing during the gala dinner last time. And so there's all these like great photos, like Bob Ezrin tweeted this like, thanks, I love the photo. And like,
oh my God, Bob Ezrin, he's awesome too.
I love Bob.
He's
amazing.
Yeah, he's great.
So there's all these, like, we've been, you know, fairly starstruck by a few people like Buffy St. Marie and Bob Ezrin being them. Is there anyone here, I mean, you've been at the Junos a few times. You've sort of done this rigmarole. So does anyone still like get you like, oh.
You know what, man? Honestly, like, I grew up in the music industry. My father owned a huge recording studio in Vancouver, an iconic one called Little Mountain Sound, where Bryan Adams got his start, in fact. So I grew up on the other side of the glass. You know what I mean? So it doesn't really hold a lot of mystique for me.
Yeah, that's fair. So your dad owned Little Mountain Sound?
Yes.
So Little Mountain Sound, in addition to, like, Little Mountain Sound is where Bob Rock started.
Yep.
All of the, this is my jam.
All the Vancouver-centric people, yeah, we all started there.
Yeah, but, like, also all of the early Vancouver punk bands. So, like, Modernettes and DOA, like, Bob Rock's first credited recordings with the Pointed Sticks, right? And he just sort of would sneak them in. They'd do all this stuff in Little Mountain Sound overnight.
Yeah,
so
they started it to do jingles, and then Bob was bringing in bands on like the weekend and stuff, and those bands were like Metallica.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
So this is your world. This
like when I was a kid, you know, like it was like Brian Johnson from AC/DC was taking vocal lessons with my mom.
Yeah.
And if I went to work with my dad, I was like, there's Steven Tyler. So like, I don't really.
You're over it.
I thought everyone was a rock star until I was about 10 years old.
You're like, everyone wears these shoes. Everyone.
Yeah,
wears
this is this was my example of adults.
And this is. Life.
And well, look what it did to me.
It made you this beautiful portrait, at least.
Wow, that is a fantastic job. I've never looked better.
Oh, thank you so much.
I love
it.
I love the color palette. It's awesome.
It was beautiful. Josh, that's for
that's
you.
That's wonderful. Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
That's really awesome. That's actually really cool. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And we'll let you get back to the sort of Jack Daniels that you need to sort of.
I'm so thirsty.
Yeah, I
so
know.
Thirsty.
You seem like you're looking parched, and I was like, somebody get this man a drink, please.
Get this man a drink.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank
Josh.
You. Thanks
enjoy,
for having me.
Enjoy the rest of the night.
All right, man.
Thanks,
you too.
Josh.
Cheers. Thanks a lot, man.
Thanks, guys. Have a good night.
So, guys, Shawn Mendes,
he's performing.
Your boy,
Shawn
mine,
Mendes is performing right
performing
now.
Performing right now.
You guys.
So,
I can hear him performing.
Yeah, I'm listening to him. Let's just like.
I can hear his silky smooth voice.
Silky smooth voice.
Through the hall.
Rebecca, I felt like we sort of didn't do enough Facebook Live stuff last night. How are the people on Facebook Live doing? Are they just screaming about Shawn Mendes?
Facebook Live.
Too? No? To the break! Izzy saying what's up? What's up, Izzy? How'd you feel about all the ginger bashing going on there? It's just unfortunately your life. Rebecca, who's doing a great job running Facebook Live, is not like the other gingers. No, I'm sorry, that's a terrible joke. This is all bad. This is, guys.
Thanks for all your comments, everybody, on YouTube. And I've been watching the comments on YouTube come in. So somebody were asking, somebody on YouTube asked, where can we send in questions? Right where you just sent that and the question.
Yeah.
So
in
there
that
you
box.
Go.
And if you're watching on Facebook Live, type them into the live box. And, you know, we'll answer them. Maybe
yes.
We'll get other members of Mary Hannah Strange to answer them also. So this was, I thought, a really nice Shawn Mendes moment earlier. So Sean Hook was walking the red carpet, and he was talking about how he lost his voice. He had to cancel a few things he was supposed to do this week, and that he was in a restaurant, and he hadn't even met Shawn Mendes yet. And Shawn Mendes, like, kind of came over and was like, hey man, I love what you do, and like, I heard you're not feeling good, and like, here's all these like tricks and sort of various concoctions to fix your throat and sprays and stuff. And Sean Hook was like, oh, thanks so much, man. So I also like the fact that like Sean Hook's not out there like, you know, trying to sabotage other people's careers or
no.
something. Is it just me, or did you get like unnervingly quiet right after that?
It is. Is
anyone else
really
like actually
right
unsettled
now.
By the silence right now? No, but like it was loud and then it just stopped. But like they should be talking. Like it is honestly sounds like there is no one in the Saddle Dome right now. It is. It's kind of disconcerting. Like someone check on them and like.
Should somebody check?
Sure there wasn't
can
like
somebody
a,
check on the Junos real
a
quick?
Chemical attack or whatever. So we have Just Rain coming up shortly.
Yes.
Another YouTuber. We shouldn't.
We shouldn't what?
We shouldn't get. I was just gonna say like, address the elephant in the room of the you know Gunna Roll and Nicole Arbor thing. Just stay away from.
I'm down to go there if we need to go there. I'm just not very aware or I'm not hip to what the news is.
Everyone here has Google. you guys can all Google. Just Rain, of course, coming up shortly, which will be great. I love Josh is like the most fun dude in the world.
This is awesome.
He is just like and he has like really intense like when you're talking to him eyes where
yes.
like he is just
I
like,
did notice that.
Yeah. The first time so I did an interview with him for another Juno TV bit and they just put in an album called A Story. It's all sort of like Goonies themed. So we did like Goonies trivia and this couple fun games with them and they were like all super game and they were great, but I kind of like sat down to the interview and looked over at him and he was like looking at me and for a second I was like and I literally went like whoa and he was like what and I was like oh nothing like he's just that he's that engaged
oh
he's,
nothing
he is like dialed in
yeah he's in he's totally engaged
pretty constantly
yes.
And it's amazing. I love it.
That was great.
Yeah, that was awesome, man.
Thanks for all your comments. I already said that but I'm gonna say it again. Please keep sending them in and
anything you good know? In there? Any real gems? Or is it just screaming about Sean?
Somebody wrote, Michaela wrote, bring him back.
Yeah, okay, that's fair. Like, more. Any other comments? Like, just more Sean.
A lot of Sean.
Yeah, that's fair. They're all Brazilian, too, right?
There's a lot of.
Huge in Brazil.
Lot of Brazil.
Like
I was
thing?
Just in Brazil last couple weeks ago.
Are you a huge Shawn Mendes fan now?
I'm a fan, but not because I went to Brazil. But I love that country. It's my first time there.
Yeah.
I love that country. I was getting my Portuguese on.
How's your Portuguese?
Obrigado.
Yeah. Oh, that sounds
that
like
means
a
thank
Portuguese
you.
Word.
That's all I really know.
It was yeah. That's sick.
Yes.
Yeah, man.
Yes, the man.
Yeah. Cardi,
you
want to come?
You guys, we got Cardinal Official coming
yeah.
in, and we want your
yeah.
questions for
yeah.
the man.
So if you guys got
I
questions,
I want to know.
Yeah.
I want to know your questions. So send them in. I'm gonna ask him. For you.
Yeah,
you guys
YouTube
get
or Facebook
to,
Live.
You guys get to talk to
hit
Cardinal.
Hit us up. I don't know that we're going to get him to play the recorder or anything like that.
Yeah, I doubt that.
And it doesn't seem like.
That's probably not going to happen.
I don't know. Like, I don't see. He doesn't have, like, a substantial bag or anything with the recorder. I honestly really love that Gunna Roll just, like, rolls with that recorder. I think it's thoroughly amazing.
It says, guy on our left mic is perfect level. Guy on our right, change the mic or pump it up a bit.
Guy on the left.
I guess my mind's perfect level.
So you guys need more.
Hey, switch mics real quick.
How's that?
How's that?
How's that, everyone? So earlier when we were doing the red carpet, I suggested that we were going to do a contest to give away the gigantic Juno statue that they had me like standing beside. So we're going to check in on that in a minute. But first, let's bring Cardinal Abishal down.
Bring him on in. Yeah. Bring the man
in.
Come on,
Cardi. Ready? Come hang.
There he is. He's here.
How's it going, man? Good to see you. So we got all kinds of stuff.
Good to meet you.
We got Mind Trap. Mm-hmm. We got Trivial Pursuit.
Yes.
We have Simpsons Trivia.
Yep.
Game Boy.
We have a Game Boy.
Uh-huh.
We have Jenga.
Yes.
And we have a deck of cards that are 3D photos of cats. I basically packed for this weekend like I was going to a cottage with my grandmother. And I was like, because, you know, you need to find a way to find common ground with people. Like, you don't. You and your grandma don't necessarily have the same interest, but you're like, well, we can play Trivial Pursuit.
And this is how you're trying to find common ground with me.
This is what I'm saying, is I'm like, would you like to play Mind Trap?
I was going
to
say, there's something, like, you could have had, like, rum.
Yeah.
Like, a stripper pole.
Yeah.
So many other things.
I heard you were really into to brain teasing questions, though. So that's
is that
why
what it is?
That's the rumor.
I mean,
that's
we can embarrass me on Juno on Juno TV. So let's
and
do it.
And you're gonna learn something, which is important too.
I think it's good. Yeah. All
right.
So often these are math questions, though. Next time we should have more rum. Apparently last year they had like a beer bucket. But
see, I'm not a beer guy because then I wouldn't be able to like fit into this jacket or the shirt.
It's
like,
key, right?
Yeah.
So I actually, I've only like recently entered my rum years.
Oh yeah.
Like I feel like I've married into a rummy family.
Yeah.
And it's like some of the best times of my life now. I feel like I'm really maturing because beer just makes you feel like a big gross a-hole.
I was gonna say, and that is gonna be the new slogan: we mature with rum. Dum dum.
That's good. That is good. Have you thought about like, or do you, maybe you already have this? Because I feel like you got your own hat.
Mm-hmm.
You got this jacket you designed with Roots.
Yes.
Do you have your own rum?
No.
Have you thought about trying to partner with a distillery? And
it sounds like a lot of mornings where I wake up and not remember who I am or where I am.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to hold out for a little bit.
Okay. Yeah. You think it'd be irresponsible?
I just think it's
to
crazy.
To, like,
yeah. It's like having my own candy
something.
Or something.
Yeah.
Like. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just feel like I'd just be gums after, like, a year. Like,
that's
my teeth
fair.
Would fall out.
You don't want, like, your own pizza or something? It would be a bad idea.
No. My own room would be cool, but I have to practice way more self-control.
Okay, yeah, that's
way
fair.
More.
Because at some point when they just start sending it to you, it's no good.
That's
right.
Right.
Okay, cool.
That's right.
All right, let's try a
But don't
trap.
Stop sending it.
Mind trap.
Let's try a mind trap question right now.
All right.
Yes.
The answer is 4.
You got it.
Mr. and Mrs. Clatter have 5 children.
Yes, 5.
Half of them are boys. How is this possible?
What?
Oh, this one's tricky.
5 children.
Half of them are boys. How is that possible?
See, all of my answers are politically incorrect.
Yeah.
Like every last one of them.
Yeah, we got to be careful. I earlier on the red carpet made a joke that I thought was being critical of negging and pickup artists, and someone tweeted at me and was like, not funny. And I was like, that's fair, negging is bad.
Half of them are boys.
So
5 children.
So think about this. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, I don't know. Do you want to work through it or do you want
to? Yeah, I
want
to work through it. Come
okay,
on,
okay.
Come on, let's go. Oh, no, I meant with you.
Oh, wait, together. Yeah. Okay,
yes,
so
yes.
Let's think about it. If half of them are boys,
yes.
There's a few options for what the other half could be.
How could there be? What?
Now, it doesn't say what the other half are.
It doesn't say they're the girls.
It doesn't say that the other half are girls.
But wouldn't, if you have children, aren't they either boys or
But I'm girls? Saying if half, you could say half of them are boys, but the other half could
also be boys.
Be boys. That's the answer. I'm telling you the answer.
I think we just lost them.
I think that sucked because you can't even do 5 like, down the, like,
I get it. That's
doesn't
why
make, it's not half.
That's true. Why it's called
not
mind
half.
Trap. It's mind trap. It's not like mind.
That's like questions
logic.
Made up by like grade Sixers that happen to be catching secondhand weed smoke questions. Like, what is that?
It's not even firsthand weed. Like, that's not even, like, you're just sort of, like, some fumes are sort of, like, floating over, and you're like, but what about half of them, I guess? Yeah.
That sucks. See, and that's why I don't do those games.
Yeah. Okay, well, I'm terribly sorry for ruining your evening.
That's all right.
But we do have Mandy from At Bad Portraits doing these beautiful paintings of everyone. So she's mid your...
Let me, can I see it again?
Yeah.
What? Oh, with the crown.
Yeah.
Oh.
King, man.
Nicely done. Good. Only my wife ever puts a crown on me, so that's kind of awesome. Yeah.
This is good, man. Yeah,
and never outside of the boudoir, so that's pretty cool. Nice.
But are you going to have to tell her about that? Be like, babe, I'm so sorry.
I mean, it's kind of live on Juno TV, so.
This is happening. Do you think she's watching this right
she
now?
She very well
she's
could be.
She's checking in, eh?
She could be checking in. She follows me on social media, so you never know.
If she's smart, yeah. I mean, that's fair. Like, I think my wife is probably watching, but, like, I'm not being crowned by another woman right now, so it's like that's not as much of a problem
Yeah,
for
you were
me.
Just calling them rummy drunks.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, I didn't say they were drunks. I said they were, like, well, okay, so, you know, there's one of the lawyers at Universal Music,
mm-hmm.
Steve, is my cousin.
Oh, really?
Is my wife. And last night, his finishing move at the bar was just to order 7 rum and cokes.
That's who he is.
I thought to share. And then, like, he was like, no, these are all, people would come up and be like, no, these are my drinks.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, guy, it's.
So I didn't know that you married into Steve's family. For sure you guys are roomies.
It's not a joke.
Yeah. No, it's like, real. Listen,
I wasn't calling these people.
I know Steve very well. Yeah. He's definitely a roomie.
He's a roomie boy, yeah.
The first time that I met him and we went to a party, he's like, what do you drink? I'm like, rum. He's like, yes.
Yeah, exactly.
And I didn't know that he was going to go all the way in like that.
Yeah, you know, he cannot have a Cardi-sponsored rum. Like, if he was getting free rum, it'd be no good.
Yeah, people would be like, listen, we're going out of business. Right?
Yeah, this is it. It's all over. Cardi, thank you so much for your time. Go grab your portrait.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I really appreciate it, man. Enjoy the rest of the night.
Thank you very much.
Oh, there we go.
Look at that. It's so dope, but at the same time, the colors, I look like a... Like almost like a chameleon, like a weird lizard almost.
You do. It's
but it's
that's
really
part of Bad Portraits. Thank you.
That is dope. Thank you.
Extremely lizard vibes. Oh,
careful.
You saved it. There you go, man.
That is wicked.
Cherish it always.
Wicked.
Oh, thank
Little
you.
Little does Ian know that he's gonna have to take care of this for the rest of the night, though.
Yeah, you gotta have someone to sort
thank
of be responsible
so
for
this
these things.
This is awesome.
Yeah. Thanks very much, man.
All right, guys.
Cheers.
Enjoy. Hopefully, I see you later. We can share a room.
Oh yeah. I look forward to it.
All right. Wicked.
Cheers, man. All right, guys, so we got Just Rain up next.
Yes. The man.
The
myth.
The man, the myth.
The legend.
The Just Rain. Yeah, come on in, man. Come hang. Yeah,
you may enter.
Just come in, man.
Accepted
yeah.
Into the...
How's it going?
Dude, you guys got Game Boys here?
Yeah, man, we got it
Jenga?
All.
A plant? What is this?
Yeah, we got it all.
Nice. Jeez.
We also have these oil-absorbing sheets for dabbing our sweat off.
For
yeah.
Dabbing.
Just for dabbing, yeah.
Should I just line the inside of my elbow?
Yeah, dab. Yeah. And then the other kind of, you know, dabbing with shatter, too. That's another great... Anyway, so...
Which camera am I looking at?
That one, and then that's Facebook.
Facebook, so, what's up, guys?
So, yeah, it depends.
You're tuned in to Facebook. Log on.
It depends who you want to talk to. So, if you have questions over Just Rain on Facebook, ask them there and we'll ask them. And if you have them on YouTube,
I'm looking at YouTube and Facebook here.
The yes. other streaming platform, you can ask them here.
Yeah.
So, earlier we chatted on the red carpet. You were saying you've never heard of YouTube. It was all new to you.
I've seen him on YouTube.
But you've seen his individual. Work before, yeah.
Yeah, he knows.
Do you feel like
the YouTubes?
The YouTubes. He's
the
been
YouTubes.
Doing it.
He's a, yeah. Do you feel like over the last hour you've learned a bit more about YouTube? You've embraced it. There's a few other YouTubers around. Have they taught you anything?
Yeah, a little bit. There's a rating system, I think.
Yeah.
5 stars.
Yeah, 5 stars.
Video.
Yeah.
1 star if it's all right. That's
you get
you heard.
Get 5 stars a lot. Do you think you get the 5 stars?
I think I would get maybe like a 2.5.
You're a good. You
I will
know
give
what?
You 5 stars every time,
oh,
man.
Geez.
There's I would say there's novelty in the middle. The 2.5 stars is an important place to be.
There's titles, video titles.
Video titles.
Subtitles.
Tags.
What?
Great part of the YouTube ecosystem.
Hyperlink
cards.
URLs.
Yeah. So earlier we had Gunnarola here. Andrew was here.
He
was playing great renditions of songs by The Weeknd. And is there pyro happening? There's pyro, right?
It's actually The Weeknd's actually performing right now. Crazy, right?
It's terrifying.
That was quite terrifying.
So for those of you that are not watching The Weeknd, blow up the Saddledome right now. I don't even know. I was like honestly so distracted by that explosion.
Who's watching us right now and not watching?
Honestly, all of these Brazilian Shawn Mendes fans.
Shouts to Brazil.
Yeah.
Shout out
Have
to
you
Brazil.
Ever been to Brazil?
In my dreams.
Oh, okay.
It was kind of like India, but everyone spoke Spanish. Okay, Portuguese, sorry.
Yeah,
Portuguese.
A little different. You know,
Obrigado.
Where has, you know, your career taken you in the last little while? Because you have done, you know, some traveling for work.
I have, yeah. I mean, I got a bunch of big projects coming out this year, which I can't talk about because there's actually a couple snipers watching me right now all times.
That's fair. Yeah, you got to keep things under wraps. That's right.
Yeah, man. I mean, it's grown just from YouTube, and which is something I just found out about today.
Yeah. We should stop. That's not. I'm sorry. I keep going back to that joke.
I've been doing YouTube for a while.
Jig is up. Honestly, it's me. I pulled us back into that joke, and I want to apologize to everyone.
Yeah.
Not necessary to return to that. What's been the greatest place that has taken you in the last little while?
I mean, I think just transitioning into, dude. I just presented an award for best country.
Yeah, that's awesome.
At the Junos. I mean, that's peak.
Yeah,
I'm not going anywhere else from here.
It's all over, right?
It's all over. It's all downhill from here.
Were you worried you were gonna like completely bomb, like say the name wrong or whatever? Like I had to pronounce a couple of names yesterday that like were names I was not familiar with.
I actually realized that as soon as I swiped to get the winner's name, I was like, how do I even know how to pronounce this person's name? But it was pretty. it was Dean Brody, so it was pretty.
So that was not, that was fine? You were
unless
like, I think
name,
I know.
Unless it was pronounced like Dion.
It's Dion Brody.
Brody.
Yeah.
Brody.
You honestly have Brody. Ruined the Junos and his career. This is quick. So wait, hold on.
Azeem. As long as you didn't say that, you're good.
That's of course, the classic.
Yeah.
So how have you guys known each other? Have you guys met
before?
I watch his videos, man.
Likewise. Yeah. And
so
we just met the FanFest last year.
Yeah, last year. Absolutely.
Which was an awesome time.
It was.
And I hope there's another one this year.
Yeah, we got really personal and close.
We did.
We did a lot of things.
You guys shared some intimate moments, yeah?
Yeah.
We shook hands.
Oh, okay. All right. That's good.
I get too excited here, guys.
So wait, hold on. Is the mechanism for delivering the winners is swiping? I'm not in there. So
yeah, what happened to envelopes?
I was not aware of that.
You have a phone, and then you swipe, and it tells you. I was like, geez. At least it's saving paper.
We're in the future.
But also wasting so much energy, right?
Is it one of those things where, like, could you swipe left if you, like, didn't think that they should have won? You're like, Dean Brody, no.
Just keep swiping till I find a suitable.
Yeah, keep swiping.
Where's my name?
You're like, oh, just
rain.
Yeah.
Where's my country single
on
this?
I won Country Singer of the Year. I'm the best.
You know what? I'm actually going to make a country album just so I can be nominated.
Sorry, I just want to.
Pickups. White people and farming. Those are the common themes, right?
White people and farming,
divorce and pickups.
Yeah.
And whiskey or brandy.
I just want to say, I don't think that you are going to win a Juno for country music.
Listen, I'm going to be the first brown male to win country artist of the year. Not even of the year, of the decade.
They're going to invent a new recognition.
They're going to be like, this guy's
for
way
your
too
contributions.
Good. He's been winning way too long.
We just got.
What would your album name be?
It'd be White White Farms. And Picket Fences.
Honestly, White Farms for sure already the name of a country album that has won
like
a
five
Juno
of them. Thing. There's already five of them.
Yeah, you're like, oh, yeah. Sorry, we made you deliver to the label. They're like, oh, God, we just put out three albums called White Farms this year. This is not
this
okay.
is the one. I'm feeling it.
Yeah. This is
me leaning by a picket fence.
Someone's got to come back and.
Rooster somewhere.
Oh. Honestly, sometimes
we should really be working on that album. Like,
yeah, you guys got to go get in
you
the studio.
You produce it,
tonight.
And
I'm down. Let's do it. You got to come down to Nashville, though.
I'm gonna definitely come down to Nashville, also for some inspiration, and just to create the best album of all time.
I think it's gonna be truly exciting to see what you guys make
Iconic,
in Nashville when you finally produce White Farms. I think it's gonna be good. who has been for you the most exciting musician or celeb that you've spotted over the course of your Juno weekend?
I mean, hey, listen, I'm always excited to see my brother The Weeknd. I've known him since he started off like way back in the day, and he can attest to that story.
He'll back you up on that.
I made his first ever sign at a show. Like I made a sign for him.
You made a sign, yeah.
Yeah, and that was his first ever sign. So we go way
and
back.
He knows. He was like, oh,
knows,
thank you
knows.
For the sign.
Yeah, he's
I appreciate the recognition.
Exactly. So I'm super proud to see where he's come.
Well, he's blowing up the Saddle Dome. We know. We heard
insane.
The explosion.
Let's see a car straight up from Brampton.
Yeah.
Amazing voice. Amazing talent. Super proud of her. Bieber, obviously, he's always killing it.
Yeah, it is like all happening for Brampton right now, eh?
Yeah.
Like I feel like people are like, oh, okay, it's not that, but like people like you're like every good basketball player is from Brampton now.
Yes.
Like pop, every good pop star, all the biggest Canadian YouTubers,
every mediocre comedian.
Yeah, all the people whose jokes are fine are from Brampton.
Are acceptable.
Yeah, everything's good
for live broadcast.
But like, am I speaking out of turn? Is that insane, or is that?
I think you know what it is. I think it's just like the GTA, Toronto. It's
yeah.
Just, there's so many different blend of like just people and different cultures that we just kind of influence each other, and different styles and just like the overall culture, whether it be language, food, art, music, influences the overall sound or art that's coming out of Toronto, whether it be comedy, music.
That's a really good point.
It is. It's true. And
it's such a multicultural city.
It's such a and you know what the thing is. There's multicultural cities all over the world, but this is one of those places that encourages you to stick by your roots and stick by that diversity and be proud of it. So as you see here with a lot of the artists, they're incorporating a lot of those elements that they've grown up with in a lot of their culture into their music. And, I mean, they're super successful because it's something that no one's ever heard before.
Yeah.
It's different. So it's amazing. Wow. That's so cool.
Oh, yeah.
I look like an old man. That's me
like
at...
Man.
That's me at 100 and... I look...
I think it's a beautiful rendition. Oh yeah.
I look like a handsome old man.
Are they worse than last night, or they're okay, right?
They're what? Good. That's good.
I look
that's
like
good.
A. I look because it's so colorful. I look like I'm a drugged version of me.
Oh yeah, it's like a very like. And also your eyeballs are like your pupils are differently dilated. Yeah.
Catch this in my vlog, you guys. I'm hanging this up because I actually need art for my new place.
Oh, yeah? Where'd you move?
To Toronto, downtown.
No, nice.
Got out of Brampton.
So that's why you were like, no, it's not Brampton. It's actually everywhere because you didn't want to feel like you
well,
had been.
I'm also from Guelph, too. Shout out to anybody who's watching from Guelph. So, yeah.
My wife was born in Guelph.
What? You're married? Jeez.
Yep.
He's got a kid, man.
Oh, yeah.
Who am I? Who is this?
He's a full-blown adult.
I'm dadded up.
This is amazing.
So that's Mandy. Mandy's been doing these.
Guys, go follow her on Twitter and let her know how.
Thank
at
you.
Bad Portraits.
At Bad Portraits.
At Bad,
bad portraits.
Portraits.
At Bad Portraits.
Bad Portraits?
Yeah, bad. Yeah.
Everybody at Bad Portraits. Let her know how amazing this is.
Follow it up.
Yes.
Follow
thanks,
it
guys.
Up. Sir, thank you so much for your time.
Absolutely.
Thank
you
for.
What?
It's a white couch.
You ruined it.
Oh, my God.
We're good.
Can't bring you
anywhere. I didn't ruin everything at the Junos yet.
Yeah, you just like totally. You almost wrecked.
What am I doing, right? Look, she's like, sick and tired of me.
This is, yeah. You were like, everyone is honestly tired of your crap, man. It's like tremendously disappointing.
Maybe I should. I can go. I can leave.
So, no, tell us more about the new spot.
Oh, it's a nice, quaint little condo.
Yeah? No art up on the wall yet, though? Or?
No, not yet.
So, the first thing you're going to hang is a photo of yourself?
Yeah, how narcissistic.
I'm just saying, like, that's maybe that's a bit much, man.
I don't think so. I'm in full support of that, man.
Who's the
just, that's it. That's just me art.
Isn't there like, is it Stroman? There's like a baseball player or a basketball player who recently like Instagrammed a photo of their bedroom, and they have like a photo like or like a beautiful painting of them like at the foot of their bed.
Yeah.
Anyway, so that could be you, man. You're like the
that.
Stroman
of
YouTube.
I would make a mural of me of like just classic paintings.
In, yeah, very
Victorian age paintings, and just put my face in it.
Well, you can hit up Mandy. She can do the rest of the movie. I'm sure. Maybe she can also do Victorian era stuff.
I really want to see that.
Get into it. Thank you so much for your time,
man.
Really appreciate it,
man.
Enjoy the rest of the evening.
I'm going to keep this forever.
Yeah, hold on to that. She's got envelopes and everything.
Oh, that was fun.
That was fun.
We are having fun. We are laughing. Here, put this for your back, man.
Oh, that's good.
Take a rest. Take a little resty rest. Here.
How are things going on Facebook, Rebecca? We got any like hot cues or takes? Any hot takes?
Looking at...
That's very.
Jessica
thank
said
you
what?
So much for like not just screaming at me about Sean Mendes. What was her name? I'm sorry. Jessica, thank you very much, Jessica. Perfectly reasonable. I hope we get lights. I talked to her on the red carpet. She was amazing. She was. She's so great. She's doing all this great stuff with Music Counts. We were mentioning it earlier.
That's awesome.
We were talking to Gunna Roll. Just like she's doing amazing work. So, I hope that you get your lights soon, please. Thank you for being raised well. I really appreciate that. Thank you so much. How are people on YouTube doing? Are they just
we're having good. We're having good.
We're having good. It's been a long couple of days, man.
It has, and today hasn't been that long yet.
I know.
A lot of bring Sean. Bring Sean. I would love to bring lights on.
Okay, yeah, we should find her. Oh, Alicia Carr just won Breakthrough Artist of the Year.
That is awesome.
Amazing.
That's great. That is huge.
That's a tough one, eh? Like I always wonder, like. Who else was nominated in that category?
Let's look it up.
I'm gonna look that up. Because like I always wonder, there was like a really nice guy that I met at the press conference. His name is escaping me. This is terrible. But
no good.
So nice, but it was like he was nominated in R&B Album of the Year. And it was like, so like The Weeknd is nominated for R&B Album of the Year.
Right.
And like, there's a lot of artists nominated. Like, and I was like, good luck, man. That's gonna, I mean, I didn't say that.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a terrible.
He said, good luck.
Good luck, man. I think it's going to happen for you. I really believe.
That's a great thing about the Junos is that you will find that. It's like you'll find that somebody will be up against somebody who is a monster and you feel like there's no chance that this person could win.
Yeah.
But because the way the Junos is, and the infrastructure that it is for voting, that it's choosing the people that win, you find artists that win that you would not expect to win necessarily because they're small artists, but the stuff that they're making is amazing.
It's true. I mean,
and you can discover artists.
Well,
really,
that's a great thing. We've leaned in on this so much as we've been talking about the success internationally of Canadian music and the Biebers and the Drakes and the Weeknds and the Alyssa Carrs and the Shawn Mendeses. But the fact is, like, when we talk about that, we are talking about a very small segment of artists. There's only so many artists that can have number one hits in America, right? So we're talking about a dozen artists, maybe. But the fact of the matter is, you know, the Junos has 42, 43 categories. So, I mean, you're talking about, you know, recognizing not just the success and the gargantuan greatness of the Weeknd. I mean, you're talking about, you know, recognizing, you know, Pomo for Electronic Album. We met him yesterday. He was amazing. We're talking about recognizing...
Who I actually hadn't heard of before.
Yeah, so he's doing great stuff, right?
Yeah.
You know, we're talking about recognizing Dinuk Wajiranti. I pronounced his name wrong, but he won for Classical Composition of the Year, and he was telling us all about incorporating pop influences into what he was doing and working with Scratch Bastard and really sort of trying to create this classical pop hybrid. And you're like, that's
so
amazing,
cool.
Man. And that's, you know, and he's not getting recognition at the level of Shawn Mendes. People are not from Brazil, like, tweeting us endlessly about him, but he's making great music and we're recognizing it
absolutely
here, which is the best.
Lots of people saying the proud of Shawn. Let's see. Leah's Forever Fashionable said she's proud of Shawn.
I'm proud of Shawn.
I'm proud of him, too. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Somebody mentioned that our set's kind of like Between Two Ferns.
Oh, it's super Between Two. We are literally Between Two Ferns. I like
maybe
that
we should too.
Less uncomfortable, but hopefully it's funny.
Yeah.
But I recognize that, like, we're not so good at our job that, you know, like, Barack Obama's going to show up. Although,
you never...
Guys, Stephen Harper is here. So, if you're watching... Please tweet at Stephen Harper and tell him to come visit Juno TV. Tell him, and if you do that, loyal viewers, I promise that we will interview Shawn Mendes for 2 hours uninterrupted.
That's great.
And we'll ask all of your questions. And
that's
then afterwards,
true.
We'll give you his mailing address.
That's true. All of this is so true information.
All of this... is true. So tweet at Stephen Harper. I don't know what his handle is. It may
PM Harper.
Is it still
PM Harper?
No, maybe not. I guess not.
It might
be. It might be PM Harper. It used to be.
Yeah.
At Stephen Harper.
So okay. So
Stephen Harper.
At Stephen Harper. So at Stephen Harper.
We have confirmation. It's at Stephen Harper.
And let's.
And we have a special guest or a gift for him if he does arrive.
Yeah, you want to tease.
And I think everybody would like to see it.
Do you want to tease? Should we tease it now or tease it?
You can tease it. You can do whatever you want.
No, please, you. It's yours.
Oh, like actually show something?
Maybe.
Oh, well, okay, sure.
I'll let you leap around. I mean, I think, so last night we almost got, Rachel Notley was here, the premier of Alberta, but then I think she had to go get something to eat, which is honestly fair. It was a long evening, and you got to get your snacks when you can. And then Nenshi... Oh, that's looking good.
Isn't that amazing?
Oh, man.
It's Trudeau as a drama teacher, which I think Stephen Harper would really like.
I honestly think if you handed that to Stephen Harper, he would have a laugh. Like,
I think
he
would enjoy it.
That's funny. It's a full goatee. He's looking make sure everyone can see that. So that's...
If you tweeted him,
yeah. So, guys, we really want to give the Justin Trudeau drama teacher painting to Stephen Harper, and we want you to get to meet Shawn Mendes. We just want the best for everyone here. That's our goal. I think that's fair to say.
Yeah.
You never know what's ahead of this evening. It could go any which way.
I know.
So you never know who we're going to get on.
Ninji was here for the red carpet. He did not stop and talk to us. You did a Instagram takeover, right?
I was on the red carpet for a bit.
What was that like? What was your red? Like, I interviewed you on the red carpet, which was hilarious.
That was funny.
There's like nothing left for you and I to say to each other.
It was a bit of a reach.
It was literally like, how long did you sleep, man? I said
two negative things. It's like in an interview. Like, normally I'm a very positive person. Yeah, I was like, I ate a burger last night. I didn't feel very well afterwards.
Couldn't sleep.
And then what else did I say?
Judo TV, we're giving you the realness. People tell you when they can't sleep because they ate a burger. But yeah, what was like your red carpet experience actually like?
It was good, man. Yeah. I got on the carpet. They held up a sign that said my name, and then all of a sudden I just stood there and I made some funny faces, and I got all the flashes, and it felt good.
I did one time a red carpet thing for Buffer Festival, which is like a YouTube festival in Toronto.
I was there this year.
Yeah, we weren't best friends yet, though. And so it was really funny. So there's like a lot of like actual famous YouTubers, such as yourself, Just Rain, like people who are really popular were there. And like I was there. And so like they had to like throw up a sign to be like, it's Sam Sutherland. And I like literally just like ran. Like I was like, this is so mortifying because guys, no one wants a photo with me.
I want a photo with you, man. Yeah.
Well, it's because we're friends. Now it's like getting a photo with your friend. We have Coleman Hell coming up soon. That is going to be good. What's been your best and worst red carpet experience before? Because, I mean, obviously you've done these before. You've done it for FanFest.
Man, when I was in Australia earlier this year, or later last year, rather, that was so cool. For one, it's like, there's one thing that, like, we're a YouTuber. We make our content most time in our home or somewhere, and for me, I make it myself in my home. So it's like one thing to be making content in your home and making videos, and it's another thing to go to another country and have people know who you are and be excited to see you. And so when I was in Australia, it was a bit of a surreal moment going on that red carpet. I went out there, people were excited. It was like a huge red carpet for the fact like they had stands and like,
yeah.
So it was really cool. And then also a really cool red carpet experience was Toronto as well, for the Fan Fest in Toronto. That was really, really awesome. I don't think I've had a bad one, per se. I'm trying to think. Oh, I did have a really bad one.
You did have a bad one?
I had one where I went to an event in L.A., and I wasn't expecting to go on the red carpet. Yeah. I was just like, oh, we're going to a party. Cool. And I think my manager was there. He's like, oh, you want to walk the red carpet? I was like, I don't think so, because I definitely wasn't dressed. You could probably go online and, like, find the picture, actually, because if you Google my name, it'll definitely come up, because it's the picture now that almost everybody uses of
it's
me.
Like
it's one of those.
Photo, yeah.
And so I'm like the worst outfit, the worst hair, like a sweaty face. And so, yeah, that was probably my worst red carpet experience, because I wasn't expecting to have a red carpet.
That's heartbreaking.
And now it's like the main picture when you come. Let's try and find that photo real quick.
Yeah, yeah. You look up that photo. I want to let people know that Nickelback are right now welcoming Burton Cummings into the Hall of Fame on stage right now in the main show. We had the pleasure of talking to Burton. It was like one of those kind of surreal things where you're like, you are literally Burton Cummings. Truly amazing. I missed a call during that. Is it cool if I call one of my friends back and just see what they were on about? Yeah, okay, so I'm just going to, while you look up that, here we go. You got to look up that photo and show it to one of the cameras. I'm just giving, my friend Justin Taylor called me. He was in the middle of talking. I wasn't going to interrupt your story to answer
please.
The phone. Hey, Justin. Oh. Hey, how's it going, man? Hold on, I'm just going to be on speaker 1 second.
Here it is.
Hey, man, what's
really
up?
Bad.
So, like, obviously, oh, yeah, okay, be careful. So why are you, like, you know that I'm doing this, so, like, why are you calling me? Oh, thanks
so
much,
nice.
Man. It's good to know that I'm getting support.
They say he's doing a good job.
Yeah, that's sorry.
Both of you guys, the whole thing, the point thing was tonight, everything is fantastic.
Oh, thanks so much. Who do you think's doing better, me or Mike?
That's so political.
Ooh, okay, that's Woo! Good. Yeah, you got to feed me that hunger.
It's about to go to you because I'm about to show this picture.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Oh,
Of course, man. I mean, I'm never too busy to ignore my friends. So, yeah, just know. I mean, I wasn't ignoring you. I was just trying to be polite to my new friend Mike. That's all.
There's more from that event.
Oh, I don't know. Okay, just if we are going to key Justin, his name is Justin Taylor. So if we wanted to key him and just, like, let people know we're interviewing, yeah, that's Justin Taylor. He was actually part of the College Pro Avril Lavigne story that I failed to tell on the red carpet earlier that I may get to later. I assure you it's a good tale. Oh, that's a bad photo, dude.
Yeah, dude.
That's
a really,
really bad
I got
photo.
One more bad one.
Okay. So hold on, we're just showing. This conversation is like the background for bad photos of Mike. Anyway, I'm gonna get back to doing this, but thanks
this
for the
one.
Encouraging words, man. I appreciate it. All right, cheers, man. Have a good night.
Thanks, brother. Good night.
Bye. Good night.
So that's good. That's so nice.
That's a good friend. I hope he got keyed. These are you're a handsome man, and these are like
these are really bad. So
terrible photos.
So this is what I'm saying. This is the photos that when like I'll do something and then I'll be at an event or something, and all of a sudden they'll pull out this photo, and we're like, why do you use that photo? So
what, like what? Why do you?
That is bad. That's bad.
You gotta like Google bomb a handsome photo of yourself, man. You just look like you look tired.
Catherine's giving me this face.
Yeah.
You don't look like that.
No, that's so nice. There's a photo of me from an early when I had a TV show, actually, that I worked on with Justin Taylor, who we just spoke to on the phone. First TV show that I ever had was called Talk Show Night at Juicebox Manor. A great show. We filmed it in my basement. We had, like, a sleepover with Andrew
WK. That sounds
amazing. The thermals played in my basement.
Really cool.
It was honestly extremely sick. But we did sort of press photos for it. And at the time, like, I had a mustache for, like, a minute. And if you Google, like, Google Sam Sutherland right now, Mike Compkin's jeans.
It was for this event called, I don't know what it is.
I just feel like, oh, people are contacting Harper? Okay, that's amazing. When you say people are contacting Harper, do you mean, like, people on Twitter or, like, tweeting? Okay, I wasn't sure because there was, like, a guy in a suit there. Is he a Harper suit? Was he? Stephen. Okay, yeah. So
you're
okay,
gonna
everyone
comment
make
to
sure.
Stephen
so
Harper.
I've been informed that when we were making all those jokes about Stephen Harper with a PH, if you're tweeting at him, there was like a guy in a suit standing here, like I'm not joking, looking like. Not amused, but like maybe amused.
I was kind of terrified for a moment.
It was a little weird. Guys, also right now, Burton Cummings is on stage. Just got a standing ovation. If you are watching the show, as great as my story is, maybe flip over and go show some respect to one of the greatest Canadian musicians of all time. So shout out to Burton Cummings. But anyway, the suit was kind of, it was weird, right? Like
it was a little weird.
It was a little unsettling. And,
But
it worked. So anyway, if we get Stephen Harper, who you should be tweeting at with a PH if you're not Canadian or if you just don't care for politics and you don't know how to spell Stephen Harper's name, I think it could happen. And then that does mean that we're going to get our 2-hour uninterrupted live stream with Shawn Mendes for
That's
you.
That's right.
Which is going to be truly amazing.
I cannot wait.
The like actual very real possibility of Stephen Harper being here and then us giving him a painting of Justin Trudeau is like... it actually makes me kind of nervous. Like, I can't tell if...
He's back. The guy with the suit is back.
Oh, hey, dear Rouge.
Guy with the
suit is
back.
Here's a question. Let's talk about this now. Let's not strategize about this when he's here. If Stephen Harper comes, can we give him the painting of Justin Trudeau? Or is that, like... As a drama teacher. So it's belittling.
He was a prime minister.
Yeah.
It's funny.
I think it's... And you'll also draw a painting of Stephen Harper, right?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, so we'd be like,
you guys let us know
some
online.
Other bad
portraits. The extra one, we'll be like, we thought you might think this was funny. Here's
yeah, or like you're an economic major. Here's a drama
That's
teacher.
That's how you frame it. Or so it's like a compliment.
Yeah, yeah, him. Yeah. So when you look at it in your bathroom, yeah, because you're hanging it above your toilet.
Yeah, of course.
Right? You'll think, I still
Brent
have a better
wrote,
degree.
Honestly, I think it'll be hilarious. So.
Yeah. Okay, that's good. So I think here's the thing: your framing of it was key because in my mind it was like we were clowning him with it, and I was like, nervous.
No. It's to remind him that he has a better degree than our current prime minister.
Okay, that's good.
So he feels good about himself.
That's good.
Yeah.
I just want to say, you know, we all have political opinions, but let's just see. Shout outs both Stephen Harper
and Justin Trudeau.
That was so political of you.
We love Canada.
Smart humans, neither of whom I have ever voted for.
Yeah, we can't say anything.
No,
yeah.
I can say. I'm just not trying to.
Yeah. We're not doing any political things.
Well, if it makes you feel better, I can't even vote.
Can you vote in America?
I can't even vote in America, and I can't even vote in Canada.
You just get to chill out.
I have no voice.
Is that weird?
It's weird, man. That's one thing
in America
weird,
right?
Like,
now, if you're living in America, and it is.
I know.
The situation is intense.
It's a bit intense, yeah. So yeah, I try to not get into conversations. Well, actually, it's kind of entertaining sometimes. So yeah, I do. But
yeah, you can't miss it.
It's very interesting to me.
So Brian Adams kicking into gear right now in the other room.
Wow. Brian Adams.
Liz Trenier was beside us for Much Music at the red carpet, and she was saying she was doing a game with everyone where they were doing like fill in the blank Brian Adams songs, and like no one actually knows the words to Summer of 69. Like it would be like, it was the summer of, you'll be like, I don't know. No one even knows what summer it is. 78.
It's the summer of 78.
It was the best. I had some good days. Everything is good.
All right, Terry Louise CV. She wrote, "We need Sean for 2 hours." So, have you tweeted yet, Terry Louise?
So
have you tweeted Stephen Harper. This has gotten really funny to me. All of a sudden, it's finally hit me. It's really funny.
It's happening. So yeah, he's not Stephen Harper, but we do have Scott Hellman coming up next. So if you do have questions for Scott Hellman, take a quick break from tweeting at Stephen Harper and send us your Scott Hellman questions. And we'll try to ask them. A couple of questions asked of me on Twitter at Nicole with a lot of O's. She was wondering who the biggest Hojo freak at the Junos is. I think I can confidently say that it was whoever we were with when we opened the show. Do you know what was happening at the beginning of the show?
Real quick.
At the beginning of the show? No, that's what
I have no idea who they were.
Jill. Yeah. At the beginning of the show, Jill is the producer of the show. Who was at the beginning of the show?
Okay, what am I about
who
to do?
That? No. Here. You don't know. Okay.
Nobody knows.
So no one knows who those three guys were.
That were with Chaos? Okay.
Friends of Chaos. Okay, so I
okay.
can confidently
I'm
say
about
those
to show a picture of these people. If anybody on this live stream
oh, yeah.
knows who these people are, just tweet at us or write in this comment.
Yeah, so if you didn't watch the opening of the stream. Yeah. Do you know who they are? They're just Chaos's pals. No. Yeah, he made a joke that he just looks like, what's his name? Travis from Blink. So those dudes, in answer to your question, at Nicole, are the biggest Hojo freaks at the Junos. But I think it's important for
that
anyone.
That was so weird that the live stream started out that way.
It was super strange.
I want to ask the person who started the live stream at that point. I thought we were just joking around. Like
no,
I didn't realize that the stream was starting.
So, yeah. So for people who weren't watching right off the top, These Hojo freaks were here, and they were like manning the cameras, and then one of them came and sat down. None of the like hardworking and wonderful Juno TV crew were seemingly here.
Sky,
and then someone was like,
the
"Okay, we're going live," and I was
sky.
Like, what?
"Yes, we're reading your comments."
And then we were live with these guys who just were like rail. Anyway, I had no idea what was going on. Didn't want to be disrespectful, but I had. Didn't recognize them, and then Chaos sat down, and that was fun. And then we eventually started the official, actual part of the stream. But if you recognize them from the photo that Mike just showed you, please, like, let us know.
Nobody knows.
No one knows.
Oh wait, somebody wrote those were the sheepdogs.
That's not the
That's
sheepdogs.
Definitely not
guys.
The sheepdogs.
I've met the sheepdogs. The sheepdogs are more respectful than that. Sheepdogs are good. nice boys. And those guys are crazy. How's it going, Sean? How's it going, Vula? So, hey, oh, hey. So, you guys want to come and sit down and chat at all? No, you're good? Okay.
Oh.
I think I'm doing, how would everyone, please, if you're at home, like, let us know in the chat how good a job I'm doing, so then I can tell my coworkers that it's going good or bad. Earlier, one of my friends called and said Mike was doing a slightly better job. But yeah, let us know in the comments so I can brag later on at the Universal party that I was good or bad. And I think, like, I think that's
pretty
important.
I said last night, I was like, I don't know how you do it, man.
Yeah.
This dude's on constantly. He can like come up with questions, and I'm like, I ask one question, I'm like, okay, cool. See ya.
I don't know why I'm trying to impress this on you, because it's not like this is my day job. Like, it's not like you're like, oh, I'm glad we have the guy who can talk a lot now working for us. Like, this is not
I'm not so
promising.
Good at the talking. I'm not going to lie.
No, you're like a good soothing presence, though.
Thank you.
Like, I think people appreciate the sort of balance that you bring to things. And then I think Mandy has been like a very critical sort of, like, I don't know what's, there's like a yin and a yang and then like the yang or whatever. Like,
thank
just
you.
Over on the side.
I should get yang tattooed on the back of my shoulder.
Like, an important
the yang to every yin yang.
I know.
So yeah. People are just freaking out because you said, hey, Sean.
Oh, okay. Thank you very much, guys. I appreciate it.
You said,
that.
Hey, Sean. To him, and he's not Sean Mendez. So
yeah,
we should clear that up.
To be fair, though, he is a Sean M.
Oh. Yeah, Terry Louise TV wrote.
So I think it's like important that we.
Did he say, hey, Sean?
Well, no, actually, you know what? I think we should tease this properly, and I should tell you that, it was Sean Mendez, but you don't get to see him until you tweet at Stephen Harper enough. To bring him on
Wait,
screen.
Wait, did you say Steve Finn?
Steve Finn. Like, Catherine pointed out that people might not know.
Oh, Finn. Like
yeah,
with a PH.
Yeah, with a PH, that's all.
Steve Finn.
Scott Hellman's here. He's just sort of hugging all the crew as he makes his way
so
to us.
So, Aaliyah's Forever Fashionable wrote, how do we tweet questions? Well, you can actually just leave the questions where you are asking that question.
Yeah, leave all
or
the questions.
Or you can tweet
here.
Us. I'm at @Mike_Tompkins, or you are.
And I am at Sam Sutherland with no vowels in the Sutherland. I have to apologize for it almost daily.
Nolan wrote,
it's truly the worst. And then you can also tweet your questions at Bad Portraits. Scott, come on in, man.
Yeah.
How's it going? Sit down.
The man.
Can I bring my drink out here?
Yeah.
For sure.
It's an adult show for adults. Put the windscreen back on.
My baby may be watching.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yo, your baby can't handle the liquor.
Juno TV.
Yeah, man, how's it going?
It's alcohol.
I know. It's all
great.
That's just how real we are
here. I saw
here.
The Red Bull, and I was like, you guys have been up for a
you
while.
You know we're down?
We've been going hard.
You know, I know you're hip.
Yeah, we're
cool with the kids.
We're trying to sort of put out a vibe here. What do you think is the key?
Whose Juno is that?
That's mine.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I won that for contemporary classical composition in 1993.
Great. You just brought it along.
I was 7, and I was really good at composing classical music, and I just thought, like, you know, I brought my Game Boy and my Jenga and stuff, and I thought I should probably also bring my Juno.
Okay.
Just to, you know, so
you
people
were quite the prodigy, weren't you?
And honestly, it all fizzled away.
So Scott's here.
So now, yeah,
Scott's
now
here.
I interview people who continue to be promising past age 7. How's it going?
Good.
Yeah.
I don't know. I might not be past age 7, though.
Yeah. What do you think was like your most promising year? What year were you like?
I mean, it depends in what capacity, because that's an intense question.
It is, right? I want you to like look back at like
when did I hit my prime?
Yeah,
is what
like
you're
at what
asking?
Point was someone like oh this kid's going like when you were like I'm going places?
Oh,
like when you were 8, when you were 12, like what was
I
what
think,
for you was like
I think
the
it's
year?
Weird. There's like levels. Like when I first got the phone call that I was getting like a meeting with a major record label.
Mm.
I kind of lost my mind a bit, and that was a big moment for me because I was like, you know, I was 15 years old. I was sitting in my friend's basement. We were watching, like, Seinfeld.
Yeah.
And then my manager.
Do you remember which episode?
The guy wasn't even my manager yet. He
yeah.
just called me, and he was like, hey, Warner Brothers wants it. It might have been the Soup Nazi episode.
Nice.
Obviously a
side note. Shout out
yeah.
Soup Nazi.
No, but yeah. That, and then, you know, when Bungalow started going to radio and really working and then I think one of the biggest moments was the MMBAs.
Yeah.
That was a huge thing. And I mean, now this, so.
Yeah, I mean, the interesting thing, like, watching the red carpet, it was so funny because, like, there was this ping-ponging that people would have to do between, like, it was like, go over and,
right,
like, talk to E-Talk, and then it was like, but then there'd be, like,
fans,
a bunch
and stuff,
of fans,
yeah,
like 6 feet behind you that totally, you're trying not to ignore or whatever. How do you, like, adjust to that? I mean, I know that's
I
a strange
really
question,
do,
but, yeah.
I think you kind of got to level out, and you got to realize that, like, if you adjust too much to it, then it becomes normal, and then
yeah,
you get weird. At least that's how I feel.
Is there any advice that people get for, like, not being weird? Like, is anyone like, here's how to not be weird? Or do you have to navigate that on your
I
own?
I think the best advice I got about that was stay Peter Pan.
Yeah.
Which is, I think, really important to be a kid.
What does that mean?
Like, be a kid for your whole life. And don't, mm-hmm, like, let that idea of adulthood take over. And you're like, okay, well, you know, I've been nominated for a Juno and play the MMBAs. I think you just got to keep, like, alive what made you want to play music in the first place. And I think that's what keeps you sane. But, I mean, some people have been weird and it's worked for them. And a great example of that is someone who recently passed away, David Bowie.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, he'll vouch for himself in interviews. Like, man, I was out of my mind.
Yeah, just steer into
but
the freaky side, yeah.
I think it just depends on who you are. And it depends on how far you want to go. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think I've gone pretty far in the weird department. I've gone down those roads of, what am I doing? Like, and is this good? And you know, you have those dark moments as an artist, but I think, you know, you just got to know where your limit is. So.
Yeah. It's interesting. You know, also when we're talking about, like, what was it? Is it done? So Mandy has been doing portraits of everyone who comes by to chat.
Okay.
She's at Bad Portraits on Twitter, and it looks like yours is already done.
Oh,
and
good.
They look,
wait,
yeah.
Wait, you drew this?
This looks really good.
Oh, that's good, man.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's so cool, man. You just made that right now?
I just made it right now.
I'm going to give her a hug.
You are.
Hug is first.
We'll just hold it up in his place.
That was Forever 21.
Oh, yeah. I love that Forever 21. Yeah, man. They're pretty good, right? You can wear it as a mask now, too. So when we were on the red carpet, I had an interesting conversation with Matt Good, who was talking about the fact this is his first Junos in 20 years.
Yeah.
Really? And yeah, well, because I grew up, I'm like a huge Matthew Good fan. Like, that was like the defining, like, first thing I was like a super fan of.
Right.
And so I was like, yo, this is cool. And then I was like, but I know, it's like you boycotted the Junos forever. And he had said that really for him, it was about sort of trying to find a way to support sort of a new generation of artists, because he's like, it's changed so much. He was like, back in the day, we'd put out a record, it would go gold in a week. And he's, you mentioned you by name, being like, you know, we played together, like we did this tour, and like things have really changed, right? And then he sees that the struggle is very different, and he wants to sort of try to lend whatever support he can to like emerging songwriting talent.
I think that's a really noble thing.
Yeah. Do you feel, have you had that support from other sort of more elder states people in the Canadian music industry?
I mean, I don't think I would be here at all if I didn't have the support from A. Ron Lapata from Warner Music.
Yeah.
Who really showed me that I could be myself as an artist, and that the only way that my career was going to last is if I did that.
Yeah.
And I mean, I owe him that because, you know, I got signed at 15. When you're 15, record label executives tell you something and you're like, okay, I have no fucking idea what to do. So, you know, he really like had that integrity of being like, you know what, we want you to be an artist and we want you to like find who you are and have that with you for your whole career, which I think is really cool. And then not only that, but you know, I think the older musical generation, like I was sitting next to Jim Cuddy at the gala, which was really cool, you know, I met Tom Cochran last night, which was also very cool.
What is
I think all those artists, every time I meet them, they're so down to earth, and they only have like wise things to say. So
it's cool.
Yeah, sorry.
I'm sorry I interrupted.
No.
I was just wondering, what does being yourself mean to you? Like, what does that mean in terms of like, what do you have to fight against in that sense? I know for me,
I think you have to like, I as an artist without all this stuff, I think you have to dig really, really deep and find out what you want to say. And you have to fight against like being afraid of being vulnerable, but also being kind of like, mysterious enough. You know, like that whole battle. There's so many things, but you also have to fight against like having other people fit you into like a, you know, like a box. Because it's so easy. Like, and you know, anytime someone's like, "What genre are you?" I'm like, "You fucking tell me. I don't know." Because I mean, then you start saying, "Okay, well, you know, I made this record, so I can't make this record now." But I mean, who's to say that? And yeah. I think there's, you know, there's always a battle. And
it's cool.
And I think you have to like, it's the whole songwriting process is so mysterious and so strange and frightening and like it's really scary because I have no idea how it works. I walk into a writing room and then all of a sudden, you know, I have a song. And you have to stay like, you have to stay yourself. You can't let people change you. So I don't know. There's a lot of stuff, but.
Well, it seems like you've navigated it pretty well so far, man.
So far.
And so, and congratulations. You got your beer.
I got my new drawing.
You got your portrait. We'll let you get back to the party, man.
Thanks. Yeah. I don't know why that conversation took a turn, but
I like
that.
It was
good.
It was nice to have a serious chat.
Yeah. No,
I appreciate it.
Cool.
So enjoy, you know, go out and, you know, now
cheers.
Have less serious chats. Cheers, man.
Bam.
Thanks
yeah,
so
thanks so much.
Good to meet you,
portrait.
Man.
I will, yeah.
Cheers,
cheers, guys.
Have a good one.
Good to meet you, man.
Cheers, man.
Scott Hellman. Maybe I asked too deep of questions, but
no,
I was actually
was
just
good.
Curious.
I really liked that it was like the genuine pause. It was like, what's that mean? It was like, oh, so real. So Letterkenny, biggest hit amongst the Juno TV crew, just announced the fan choice winner as Justin Bieber. I am going to see Justin Bieber in May. And I'm okay.
In May?
This is great. Yeah, in May. He's playing in Toronto.
Amazing.
I bought my wife tickets for her birthday. I bought her two tickets. And was like, you can take whoever you want. And
she picked you?
And she picked me.
Yeah.
So I'm getting to go. Apparently, someone was telling me about a review of him, of the show, and that they said it was like part concert, part sermon or whatever. So I'm like, I'm pretty excited. So
that's
congratulations,
amazing.
Justin Bieber, on the Fan Choice Award. That is... truly great and truly well deserved. What a year. So I think we are going to have the Letterkenny guys up to chat. How are things going in our, speaking of chats?
Lots of, oops. I lost it for a sec. Coming back here.
Yeah. Oh.
We need Sean and we need him for 2 hours.
Sean, Justin,
Charlene.
Sean.
Charlene?
So,
guys, we have Celine Dion coming up next.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, no. That's not, I read that wrong.
Oh, and guys, more winners coming in from the other room. Weeknd just won Album of the Year. So congrats.
That's amazing.
To the Weeknd. That album is so good. Is that, yeah, we got the portrait of him. There you go. So
yeah,
Mandy's
I don't know if this is working, but I think.
Show this camera.
Boom.
Oh yeah, it's like that's a really good. Also, like the curve of his mustache makes him look like a little bit. It's like magician-y vibes, like because it sort of looks like there's a mustache and then like it's and then the soul patch. Like I don't mean that as a criticism. I mean that as like I like it. It like adds a, like a yeah. An aura of mystery. I think.
Yeah, well, I think you can tell that I suggest facial hair all the time.
Yeah, facial hair is definitely like sort of. On the table in a very serious way when you're painting.
So those who want Walk Off the Earth, there is Walk Off the Earth, people wanting Walk Off the Earth.
Yeah.
My idea is, I know Walk Off the Earth.
Shoot
so
a text.
You guys send them a tweet and then also at me in the tweet and I will favorite that tweet.
Oh, and so it'll bump
it'll
in.
Show
and
up
they'll
on
get
theirs.
Pinged.
Okay?
So, okay, so that's
so
good. So
I am Mike _ Tompkins, TOMPKINS.
Send
no
those tweets.
H. There's a P in there. TOMPKINS, Mike _ Tompkins.
Not Tompkins.
Just Tompkins.
It's a tough one because it's like an easy white person name, but it's also.
It's
there's,
so white person.
There's
name.
Variations, there's subtle variations. We want
there's
to take an opportunity.
Man from Walk Off the Earth right there.
Oh, yeah. Well, but we make it seem like
right, yeah,
organic.
Sure. Yeah.
I want to take this opportunity to remind everyone at home that our friends and yours at Google Play Music will be offering streaming of all of tonight's performances following
the show. Shout out
to
Google Play.
Shout out to Google Play. I do.
Shout out to them.
And this is true, and I'm not personally being paid by Google Play. I use Google Play. It is my streaming service of choice, and I'll tell you why.
Why?
Because it has that thing where it not only like matches your music collection, but it'll upload tracks that you have that aren't already on a streaming service. So if you're like me and like half of your iTunes collection is actually demos of punk bands from Oakville in the early 2000s, all of a sudden that music is available to you everywhere. So if I want to like listen to the Pettit Project on my phone, if I want to listen to a 2 minutes too late demo, I can enjoy that. I want to dig into Etobicoke punk. It's there for me to cherish. Blue Van, all the hits that are not on streaming services, they're there for me.
That's awesome.
I know. It's a good story, right?
So thank you, Josh Walker. He tweeted Walk Off the Earth.
Oh, and you faved it?
And I faved it. So some people are writing, come to the Junos backstage. We got to make sure we say come to Juno TV.
Right.
Live stream, so they know to come here.
Juno TV. Be sure to include Juno TV in that. Because, yeah, otherwise, there's, like, other outlets here that you don't want them to go to the Globe and Mail.
No.
Because the newspaper is for nerds. Sorry, I subscribe to the Globe and Mail. Shout out to the Globe and Mail. Didn't mean that. Mandy, I know you're mid-drawing, but can I ask you some cues?
Yeah, sure.
So
let's go for it.
You've now drawn, like, a healthy number of people.
Yeah.
Who has been your favorite person to draw? Like, which one were you, or who were you the happiest with?
For the Junos?
Yeah, or is happy,
well,
like,
on
not
Juno
what you're
TV?
Going for? With
I really loved Brent Kissel's, like, he was so kind. He was such a sweetheart.
He was amazing.
His portrait was okay.
For those of you guys who didn't see it yesterday, Brent Kissel came back. Immediately went for the 3D cat cards that are from my friend Claire Richardson, shout out at the ClaireBot, and like immediately played Mike and I in a game of blackjack where he won, which is suspect, and then was so stoked on his portrait.
Yeah, he was just such a sweetheart.
Yeah.
And then White Horse's portrait was like really weird. Because it was at the end of the night, and we were, like, begging Roger for food. We didn't get food.
Yeah.
I think I was a little delirious. So the portrait came out, what I thought was awesome.
Yeah. So that's, like, the perfect space for you. It's, 4 hours of just sitting there painting and, like, eating. And that's fair. It's the opposite. Yeah. But for sure, like, by the end, my interview with White Horse was, like, you're both so beautiful. How do you do it? Because let's be honest, and I'm just saying, like, waiters are like the best dressed, beautiful musical couple I've ever known.
Yeah, probably. Yeah.
In the world.
Yeah, I think so.
Like,
I think they should. That's why they won the Juno. And no, I'm just kidding. They're amazing musicians.
Well, I mean, it's a recognition of the holistic package.
Right.
Yeah. Anyway, so that's good. If you didn't see any of those last night, they're all on Mandy's Twitter at Bad Portraits, and you can check out the Bob Ezrin portrait. You can check out the Buffy St. Marie portrait. You can check out those portraits we were just talking about. They're so good. You can see portraits she drew of Mike and I that are awesome. Rebecca, anything good happening on Facebook Live chat? Or are people just asking for lights in a polite manner still? That's it? I love how nice everyone is on Facebook.
Austin Oswald, official, been tweeting Walk Off the Earth all night. So
someone's
you got to tell them to come to the live stream, the Juno TV live stream.
So apparently we're about to get Nickelback. Which is the big fish. It's I think Nickelback have won like 12 Junos or something, like 35 Junos. Also, I should mention this as a plug because it is only fair. If someone complimented my jacket on Facebook, Forever 21, they have outfitted both Mike and I. Not entirely. This is actually my tie. just to brag. I just don't want to give them credit.
This is full.
For like,
this is the full deal.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. These jeans are Forever 21.
Dude, I like this jean.
The shirt's Forever 21. This is a good shirt. Like, yeah. The jacket is honestly great.
Yep.
I got to say, I look amazing.
You look great.
So, you know what? And
all
you,
right.
You also
I love
look
that
really
comment. Mike.
So, sorry. So people know
Mike
there's...
Mike may need to move to make space for Nick.
So, there's an iPad located, like, right above this camera that just lets us know, like, you know, like Scott Hellman is coming soon, blah, blah, blah. And that's sort of
all right, you guys. I'm going to move.
They're not here.
I'm going to move.
Anyways, so a message just popped up that just said, in the most polite way, Mike may... Sorry, Mike, take a look.
I love you, too.
It said, Mike may need to move to make space for Nickelback, which, like, it could have just been, like, Mike needs to leave. Anyway, and now it just says, love you,
super
Mike.
Polite and Canadian.
Yeah. It was extremely, it was like the most, we are definitely at the Junos ever. So if we do get Nickelback, you guys should, honestly, because I can't look at the screen. So if you have any questions for Nickelback, you should tweet them at me. Because this will be the easiest way for me right now to get a question into Nickelback. So I'm at Sam Sutherland, SamSthrLnd. And yes, I know that is, it's a dumb handle. So that's at SamSthrLnd, which is like my name, but with only some of the vowels removed. And let me know what it is you would like to know. Amazing. Okay, so is she coming on? Yeah. Come on in. So before Nickelback, we have enabler of the Nickelbacks of the world. Come on in, Melanie Jolie.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Fine, you?
I'm doing great. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here.
We have been trying to... engage the people watching to like tweet at the politicians to
yes.
show up, so I'm so glad that you are here. And as heritage minister, I mean, this is obviously, you know, you are responsible for so much of this.
Yes.
And enabling the great art scene of this country. It's amazing. We were talking to earlier a woman who was nominated for Eva Michon. She was nominated mm-hmm. for Best Director of mm-hmm. Music Video. And I was like, why are Canadian music videos so good? And she was like, it's because of Arts Fund. And there's more people able to make more interesting art in this country than in other countries.
And we believe as a government to reinvest in the arts, and that's mm-hmm. what we did. We announced $1.9 billion in our budget. Mm-hmm. That's the biggest reinvestment in 30 years. And I would add, it's one of the biggest reinvestment in the world right now, because some people have the tendency or the ideology that, you know, when you try to have austerity measures, basically you need to cut arts and culture. Mm-hmm. I think this is wrong. Mm-hmm. In order to grow the economy, you need to have really a strong innovation ecosystem. Mm-hmm. And the people that are really at core of that innovation system are the creators, the content creators, the artists that we have. Mm-hmm. And they will have then an impact on others, maybe like the professionals, the engineers, the architects, and even the entrepreneurs that will develop new technology and then afterwards create growth. Mm-hmm. So it's all linked. We are all linked. And that's why it's so important. Events like tonight are so important, for the Canadian population to understand the importance of the music industry. But I would add that it's also important to invest in arts and culture in order to really grow the economy.
Well, it's interesting. I mean, you mentioned, you know, sort of baked into that is this idea that it is occasionally, you know, a little critical. Is that the... Oh. You gotta go. I was gonna like really delve into like.
No, but it would. I would.
We'll
love
do it later.
It.
We'll do it later. I'm gonna be at the Universal Party later, and
okay,
we'll get in the mix on like policy discussions. But thank you so much. It's extremely meaningful. So thank you so much
thank
for your
you.
Time.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Thank you.
That was Minister Melanie Jolie, and we got a portrait going on here.
Yeah.
Okay, so Mandy at Bad Portraits has been. Painting all of the, how far along are we on that?
It's almost, so probably about 2 minutes.
So maybe we can, so of course Mandy doing At Bad Portraits. You can, I guess, just go and hang out over there. Mandy's beautiful portraits of everyone. Oh, and now we got Nickelback. Come on in. How's it going, sir?
Hola.
Good to see you. We got a lot of microphones here. Bringing the whole team.
Good, you?
I'm doing just great.
Good.
I've just been back here chatting away.
I'll slide on.
Yeah, slide on in. Slide on in, guys. Hold on, I'm going to steal one more mic.
Ben Knatchel. Did anyone say hi to Ben?
Did
anyone say hi to Ben?
I did. I gave him a hug.
You're the last one.
I saw him an hour ago.
So, Ben, who is directing the show, used to work with your record label, at your record label. Is that correct? Is that that's the connection? And he would be like, honestly, like, Chad's like the coolest guy. Like, he would just call me up and be like, I need you to meet me at the, like, whatever airport. And we just
like
get
a
on
drug
a jet.
Deal.
Well, that's,
I need you to meet me with the best.
He's got taco socks.
I need you. Yeah.
Are those tacos?
Taco socks,
that's yeah. actually happened before.
Yeah, and it was I like, it's actually happened and before. We just Socos. Get on his jet. And we would just, like, listen to AC/DC, and we'd fly down to L.A. and, like, drink beers. And I was like, oh, my God, Nickelback have the greatest life of anyone in the world.
Only when Ben's around.
Only when Ben. So is the, have things,
ladies and gentlemen, Ben.
Have things not been the same since our director Ben left 604 Records? Has it been tough?
Better days. The better days.
Tumultuous.
It's been tumultuous. Yeah, that's fair.
It hasn't been the same. Ben, what's it like to know that, like, the whole interview is going to be about you?
It's we're just,
is that
weird? We're leading in hard.
Is this weird?
When we talked to you guys on the red carpet, it was almost entirely about socks. And then here it's, like, all about our director, Ben.
Yeah.
You know, you guys have probably had to do maybe more interviews than anyone that we're going to talk to tonight. So, like, by and large, like, what was the biggest disaster of an interview that you've ever experienced?
They sedate us now.
Oh, so now
we're just getting started here. This could be it. We can make it. We can notch it up right here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Honest. You just get nothing but honest sauce.
Oh, okay. Honest. Okay, great.
So we got honest.
Honest sauce. Then, like, who is your biggest, like, secret beef with?
Beef.
Yeah.
Secret beef.
Secret beef.
Beef.
Ryan.
You know what? It's yeah. That's
really?
Pretty good.
Yeah.
You know what it is? Seriously,
wrestlers from the 80s.
Yeah. I think there's only one person.
I think it was Ziggy.
There's only one person that does this. When you're driving through a parking lot and there's a person that's sitting in the parking stall with their car in reverse, I hate that person.
Oh, okay. So
because I want them to back up and they don't back up, and then I go to pass and they start backing up.
See, Mike with tamale so that you can
hate
relax.
Him.
Just that guy.
Yeah. That guy. You, stop
things,
this.
Right? These are the things that really set Mike off.
These are your problems. Yeah.
You
I
asked.
Get it, man. It's fine.
You asked.
That's the real honesty that we get from a couple of drinks is, like, people who drive badly. It is truly terrible.
Trying to be as vague as possible.
Yeah.
You're late. It's rush hour, right?
Are you going to explain this?
No, I'm going into this one now.
Oh,
new one.
We're going into traffic. This one pisses me
off.
Okay,
yeah, no, I think this is important.
If you're going to take a left, okay, get out into the intersection. Just get in the intersection.
Yes.
What are you afraid of?
Yeah.
Get out in
the
intersection.
Okay.
It's a fear of commitment.
Okay?
It's just a
I'm
fear of commitment.
You. Yeah. I want to go. Stop
afraid to commit.
Acting. This is method acting. He's putting himself back in the same spot.
Yes.
Yes.
We got some hell yes in the back. We got hell yes everywhere.
Random people that have nothing to do with what we're doing are hell yesing from over there.
Yeah, we got hell yes all over the place.
I got an amen. Can I get a hallelujah?
The nerve of people being on a sidewalk when you're in a hurry, right?
Oh.
Nerve.
No, when people walk like three people abreast on a sidewalk. And then they're walking slow. It's like, if you're going to sort of
look
be in a squad,
I
like
walk
you look truly
angry.
Furious on
angry.
That stream. We asked for some questions on Twitter. If you want to send them to me, keep tweeting them at me. One of them specifically was about which hair products you guys use. People were admiring the sort of body on the hair.
Mike, what
I've been using an invisibility serum on my hair lately.
It's
I don't know if it's working.
No.
I haven't been past the mirror for a while.
It's a lot of money.
It is
telling you it's going to be
it's
fake.
Working.
Yeah. So those are the questions that we used when you said you would be honest about everything. We asked about hair and traffic, and now you guys got to go get back and party.
I know.
Unless you just want to hang out.
We're partying right now.
It's the important thing.
So okay, I basically packed like a variety of games. We have
but
a
this
game
one looks like
Tetris.
It was honestly yours from.
Oh, that is my Jenga. This is not a
original.
Joke.
That's
yeah.
That is a worn
that's
cardboard box
that
right
is,
there.
Yeah, like it's taped up together.
It's
I was
been
really
around.
Worried it was
oh, you've got
in
the masking tape. That is so real.
No, that's
classic
like,
masking.
This is real Jenga.
that's like circa 80-ish.
Like, sure who would be here and like who we should talk to? I was like, maybe we'll need some games. We played Mind Trap with Cardinal off a shell.
Yeah.
Like that was pretty fun.
Somewhere there's a jar of like the peanut butter that. It's like half oil somewhere
yeah.
here. Where
yeah,
is it?
No, it's basically
it's
a cottage. basically. We want to do some of these?
Wait,
let's
hold
do
on
it.
A second. Are we doing this? What are we doing?
What are we doing here?
Mike.
Ready?
Yes.
What color is diamond dust?
Black.
He's right.
Oh, all right. Mike knows
he's
his
right.
diamond.
I know my diamond dust. What can I say?
This is a question for the whole band. What's the main ingredient in glass?
Sand.
Silica?
It is sand.
Silica.
No, it's silica. Come on, guys. Yeah.
Yeah, man, I know things.
He's a glass specialist.
You guys have been all around the world. What country has the most coastline?
Most coastline? The country that has the most coastline?
Canada.
Greenland. I'm going to say,
I think it's Canada. The answer is Canada.
Boom! Island.
Celebrating Canada.
Drops got Mike.
Just randomly pulled that one out. Of
I know, I was like, I'm so good at my job. This is amazing.
Where were we on that
in
one?
In the middle of asking us the question, he was patting himself on the back.
No.
He's like, you've got to
when
be kidding
me. Honestly, I didn't know, and when I flipped it over, I was like, holy shit, I did it. So we have Mandy over here.
Hi, Mandy.
Mandy. She runs a great Twitter account, at Bat Portraits, and she's been doing portraits.
Well, you're doing the portraits so nicely.
You went old school?
Super old school, oh man.
Does that mean Chad has hair in this one?
A tribute, okay. And so I these have been... These
wait, so I've got like brother, long, I got long hair. Luscious.
Do I have hair?
It's going to be... Let's...
Because you don't have the internet.
What is this? Yeah, right.
Let's see it.
Is this some kind of like Da Vinci? Whoa.
Oh,
not that old school. Who's
that guy?
Christ, what happened to me?
It looks like Jug. Is that
that's
Jug
me.
Guy?
That's me. She actually mixed up putting me in the band.
I like.
Yeah.
If we were crossing.
Thank you. That's very punk rock of
if
me.
If we were crossing like an international border you. Without passports.
Yes, that's my.
Who's the guy with the purple fucking hair?
I never would have. Yes, exactly.
There's a lot of action happening there. So that is yours to keep. To
all right.
There's a new
it's like one
band
of those
here?
Game shows where you say the wrong word and the music
yes!
starts.
Yes.
Why'd that stop? I was just about to snap
I thought
I was hanging.
I
with
thought
Nickel
I was gonna get slimed because
yeah,
said,
I thought
it,
yeah, you said I don't
said,
know.
Fuck
or something.
I said, boom.
Okay, yeah, we gotta.
We gotta do a quick selfie for Juno.
Okay.
Do
okay.
It, do it.
Woo.
Yeah.
That's fine. It's fine. I'll deal with it. It's fine. You guys look cool. It's not about me. No
great.
One cares.
Great.
Yeah.
Thank you. We'll fix all right. Post, don't worry.
I know exactly.
Look at Ben. Ben's like, get off the set.
No, like,
get
like,
off the set.
I tried to wrap it up before Trivial Pursuit. I mean, I was doing my job. Guys, thank you so much for your time. Enjoy your. Good luck crossing a border with that thing. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. Cheers, man. Thank you so much. Okay. Yeah. Here. Well, it's like real delicate air traffic control here. Thank you so much. Yeah. Thanks so much, sir. That was really fun. Thank you, man. Loving that invisibility cream. It's looking good. I mean, you can just hang out. We can play Jenga or whatever. It's fine. All right. So, guys. I'm so sad that I missed like an almost an opportunity to
that
Snapchat me hanging out. It's no good. So sad that I missed an opportunity to Snapchat myself, like listening to Klezmer music while sitting on a couch with a Nickelback. In that moment, I wholly abandoned the notion of like being professional and was just like, "This is too special
cool.
of a moment."
We got one. We got one moment where Chad went,
"Yeah!"
I know. You know
right?
We got that's all
yeah
that's all I really wanted. He went, "Yeah!"
Guys, what a beautiful time to be alive. So,
what a beautiful time to be alive.
It appears that your tweets and prayers have worked. Mike using the faving power of his verified Twitter account. because, by the way, guys, that's how it works. If a verified user like tweets at you or retweets or like you get an alert because Twitter's like, you might actually
you
care
might
about
be interested
this.
In this.
So,
you guys did it. You guys did it.
Oh, Snapchat.
We collaborated together.
So,
thank you guys for tweeting Walk Off the Earth.
Someone on Facebook was asking about Snapchat. I'm on Snapchat at Sam Sutherland.
And
no
I
vowels in the last name. SamSTHR.
Dude, you are branded all around. That's the way to do it. That's
guy,
the way to
I
do
know
it.
What I'm doing.
I'm a little wonky. Mine is Mike Tompkins 87. So when I first started my Snapchat, I was like, oh, this is like when Snapchat just began. And I was like, oh, I don't really necessarily want anybody to know my
right,
Snapchat
it's a private
name.
Thing. Yeah, I get it.
But then I just started putting it out there that this was my Snapchat
yeah.
name, and now it's that's yeah. my Snapchat name. Mike Tompkins, 87.
Well, guys, the
we got Walk Off the Earth
the
coming
magic of
up
Twitter
next.
Has, I think brought Walk Off the Earth to you. So if you have questions, you want to, you guys are pals, so I'll let you run this. I'm gonna grab the computer.
Oh, I don't know about that. I don't know. I might still need you.
Nectal. Yeah, the ongoing theme of this weekend is 3 days grace,
threatening
our director.
Don't fuck up. Don't fuck
Yo, we're keeping him in line. Don't worry, it's fine. We're good. Yeah, come on in.
Yay!
Come on in, guys.
Come on in. Join the party.
How are you?
Join the party. We got plenty of party.
All right. Party time. Hey, we got a party.
What's up, you guys? We can all smush in.
Oil absorbing sheets.
Who's this dude? What's his name?
This is Giorgio.
Giorgio.
Yeah.
Love that name.
What's up, Facebook?
How is Giorgio?
He's got almost three.
Three.
Yeah.
Wow. I have a 7-month-old. Oh, 7-8-month-old.
Joel, he's gonna have to sit on your lap.
Oh, you guys are in it.
No, we're in it.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Woo! That's intense.
Oh, look at the delay.
And so you're on the road. How does that work?
We bring them with us.
Yeah, that's awesome.
As you can see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's such a cool. I admire that so much. That's so amazing.
Thank you. Yeah, it's a crazy time. We're like,
yeah, eight month old, a 3 year old, and you just won your first Juno.
Yes, our first Juno. We've had a few nominations.
You've had a few nominations, but this is your first win.
The first win.
I'm so excited for you guys.
Thank you.
It's so cool to see your kind of rise from my standpoint, because we both started posting videos online around the same time.
Yeah.
Likewise. And so cool to see you guys here today at the Junos, winning your Juno.
Trying to father.
So that was good. This is important.
Like
that's priority number one, by the way. That's priority number one.
Yeah,
how you guys doing down here?
Oh, fantastic. Very
you guys
good.
Won a Juno tonight. By the way, I love the Hold On video.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh. And my man here, he just keeps holding on. If you guys haven't seen this video yet. It's honestly an amazing video, and this guy just keeps holding on to a pipe for a very long time. How do you do it, man? What do you do?
Well, the trick is to not do much.
Until you have to.
And that's it, folks. You don't have to do much to hold on to a pipe for a very long time.
I got to say, we brought all of this, stuff, various toys, because we really weren't sure, what we were going to do for 2.5 hours, how many people were going to come back, how much lag time there would be, and I'm finally seeing the payoff right now.
We can give you something to do for 2 hours.
Yeah.
If you want to babysit, here we go.
Yeah, we're just bored back here, so I would love daycare. To sort of just hang out with some kids and play Jenga, I think.
I'm just surprised it's not the drinking Jenga, the one that has the different little things you have to do.
Yeah. No, as pointed out earlier, we just had Nickelback on, and they were like, yo, this is your Jenga, eh? Because if you look at that case, I mean, it's taped up, that Jenga's been in my family for generations.
Yeah,
wow. Look at the masking tape, everyone. Look at the masking tape.
That's a family game right there.
That screams 1993 to me.
Yeah. For sure.
Yeah, that's a good one.
OG.
What are the games that the kids are playing now? Is Jenga still is this the first time that they've seen Jenga?
Yeah.
Or is Jenga, so it's not. What's the cool board game for the youngsters in 2016.
There is a Jenga that exists right now, but it's it has a lava pit around it, and it's digital, and it explodes if you push the things the wrong way. There's one in my house.
The future's so weird.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's futuristic.
It's a crazy place. Crazy place.
Humans are stepping it up. We're always stepping it up. One more notch.
Now, you seemed excited about Duke Nukem. Did anyone have a favorite video game growing up? The thing that defined your childhood?
I have to say that I was pretty genius at Super Mario Brothers 3.
Oh, yeah.
That was, I would come home from school and play that every day.
I was playing.
I didn't have a lot of friends.
I was playing Super Contra.
Wow.
Good game.
Yeah. The hardest
Super Contra?
All time.
Dude. Contra. The best. Up, up, down, down, left, right, BA, select, start.
I
That's
love
it.
The Aladdin
That's
game
it.
Yeah. Sega Genesis, the Aladdin game was amazing.
It was a good game. I was a Sega Master System person who no one knows anything about. It was before Sega Genesis. I was the only one on the whole street. So if there's any other Sega Genesis, out there.
Sega Master System?
Sorry, Sega Master System. That's
wow.
I've not heard of that.
Yeah, it was the rival of Nintendo that got crushed. And
got
my dad
it.
Got convinced into buying it for me, and then I had never anyone to trade games
was
with.
There, was there Sonic on it?
Sad story.
No,
I did
it
have
was
a Dreamcast.
The Sonic Hedgehog.
Do you remember Dreamcast?
I do.
Dreamcast. I played one game on it. It was tennis.
I had tennis. That's all I had.
Does anyone remember?
But I really liked
Boy?
It.
Did any of you guys ever play? Yes. That was a weird one. That was a mistake, I think.
They were all the way there with the technology yet. It was mostly just a headache causer.
Yeah, it was bad. So we've got Mandy over here at Bad Portraits on Twitter, who's been doing these beautiful paintings of everyone throughout the night.
Look at this.
That's awesome. Thank you.
I look better in this than I do in real life. Thank you, Mandy.
That's amazing.
That's killer.
Do we get to
very
keep
cool.
that?
Or
that's yours.
That's ours.
Yeah. That's
thank
yours.
You, Mandy.
So that is yours to keep. We'll let you sort of.
Okay.
We'll just cut out each member, and each member can take themselves home.
That was someone was like, "How do we divide this up?" We're like,
or
"Either take yourself or take your favorite member."
Or maybe Mandy could whip up like four more of them.
Yeah, real quick, Mandy.
Sure she can just
Mandy,
sort of, yeah.
Can we get four more of those?
See?
Yeah. Beard guy looks a little bit greasy like, on this one, so we'll we'll dab him down. Yeah.
Okay.
Dab him out.
We'll let you continue to party into the night and run this gauntlet, but congratulations on everything.
Oh yeah, you have no idea what we have planned.
I feel like it's about to get wild.
It's gonna get crazy.
Is my impression. Yeah.
Guys, thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you so much for your time.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Good to meet you guys.
Yeah, you too.
Wow, did you ever just
so good. Yeah, it's bad.
I'm so into this. So guys, we got Sean Hook coming up next.
Are you really doing this
now? Oh, here you go. I was gonna try to steal it, but yeah. Cheers, man. Congratulations. Oh, I'll put that away. You guys don't have to clean this up. That's fine. Yeah. You want a Juno, you don't have to clean up my Jenga. Like it's not your job.
We're total parents. Today.
I like knowing that's the kind of house guests you guys are, right? Guys, let it be known.
Mike Tompkins is on cleanup duty.
I think it's a very have a good night.
I just said that in the third person.
Let it be known, guys. Walk Up the Earth are for sure the only artist that are going to have their kid throw jank everywhere and then clean it up instead of just leaving the house. We're going to bring Sean Hook in, man. How's it going?
It's going well.
Thank you.
We got mics.
Can you hear me? Check, one, two, two.
Check. Apparently when I step on these things, they start to...
Oh, no. It got rowdy. Who won?
No one. Apparently.
No one.
Nobody
yeah.
wins.
Yeah, no one wins.
It's just about who... Real question is who lost.
Yeah.
It's me because I have to clean all this stuff up.
Red Bull.
Yeah.
Jenga. And Game Boy.
Yeah, we got it all.
This is like back in the day in high school.
Also, we have these oil-absorbing sheets.
Oh, that's smart.
So it's not just about partying. It's also about looking dry.
It's about vanity.
Which is good.
Right.
It's important.
Chad, what's up? I had to change my suit. Thank you. Thank you, Chad. I appreciate it.
Are you concerned about spilling on this right now?
Three. Well, Chad spilt on my first one, but it was an omen. It was a good omen.
Chad Kroger spilled on your... You messed up this guy's first suit?
But it was a good omen.
Guys.
How'd you do?
I think I did all right. I don't know.
They pulled me backstage.
It's okay. Next year.
real life conversations happening.
Thanks, Chad.
So what was the original suit that Chad
It was out? The red one. Orange, red, whatever.
Yeah.
Reddish orange, bright hues and tones.
Okay, well.
Once again,
I believe it. I mean, if this was the backup suit, I can't imagine what the primary suit looked like. Yeah. So this is a great suit, man.
Thank you.
I would be terrified to wear that much white. Like,
well, I think there's like a makeup stain here somewhere.
There's a big, there's a
gotta be careful who you hug.
That's the thing. Yeah. No more hugs.
No more
Sean
hugs.
Hook 2016.
Hashtag.
You gotta shut it down. For
hashtag
sure.
No more hugs.
So besides some makeup hugs, how's your night been? We talked a bit out on the red carpet.
Yeah.
It has been a little crazier.
Yeah.
That was sort of the tip of the iceberg. So what's the last 2 hours been like for you?
I mean, it's my very first time performing the Junos. My heart was pounding at the very beginning. Super emotional night for me. My family's in the audience watching.
That's
and
awesome.
It's my grandfather's ring. And he taught me, he got me into music. And I was just looking at this all night. And the last performance with Jan Arden was just everything. She's been such a big influence for me growing up. So this night's just been so memorable.
That's amazing, man. Sorry, that's amazing. That's your grandfather's ring.
Yeah.
Right? That's
yeah.
fantastic. That's
yeah.
really nice. Do you still get nervous performing? Because I think that's so interesting. Because at the level you're at, like how often is your heart going like that? Like, is this like new, like over the last year to have that happen?
This was, yeah. I mean, I usually get a little nervous before the performances, depending, you know, how many people there are. Although for the little ones, I get a little nervous too. But
yeah.
I was fine. It's good to have some nerves. Because if I'm not, then I'm not prepared.
Yeah. Or you're just like maybe not putting kind of enough into it.
Exactly.
Maybe like,
exactly.
You want to make sure you're still a bit on edge, right?
Yeah. Exactly. Exactly.
So now that it's all, now that like the terror is all over, like, oh. Man.
Oh wow! Who did that?
That was quick.
So this is Mandy.
Oh wow, Mandy! That's amazing. Wow, incredible. I'm going to frame that.
So she's been doing these paintings for everyone. She's turning them around in like 2 minutes.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
How long that you just did that? That's amazing. Amazing.
Maybe I can wear it and like get into cooler parties tonight. Like if I just cut it out and put it on my face, I'd be like, hey, what's up? It's me, Sean Hook. Let me into this much cooler party than the one I'm probably
Where are you going
to
go?
I'm going to go to the Universal party.
Okay, that's where I'm going to be.
Like, I'll see you
in the same party.
Yeah, okay, well, cool. But, like, maybe there's, like, another door that I'll get through or whatever.
Maybe.
Like, if you, I don't know.
I don't know. Did you see when Paul McCartney got, he got,
in
LA?
Oh, my God, yeah.
Him and Beck.
It's him, Beck, and,
Taylor Hawkins, the drummer.
Getting turned away snubbed. From,
T-Pain's party? Or no, not T-Pain. Sorry, T-Pain. I can't remember.
It was, yeah, you didn't see this? It was, like, party after the Grammys, and it's like Paul McCartney, Beck, Taylor Hawkins getting turned away.
They're like,
I don't remember who it is.
Paul's like, how much more VIP could I get?
Yeah, like,
Sir Paul McCartney.
Like, he's taking it in sort of good, but the best thing is, the TMZ photographer's just like, Sir Paul, and you're like, the TMZ guy is being more respectful.
Yeah, so I'm not going to be able to have any pull tonight, I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah, that's fine.
Because we don't even have Paul.
Yeah, exactly. If Paul doesn't have, if Paul doesn't have Paul's pull, then who can pull?
Paul.
Paul.
Peter?
Yeah, I don't know, something like that. Something like that.
That's good. I like where you're going.
What are you going to do? What's going to be your first move when you get to the party? Are you going to, like, do you want to go into a corner and, like, not talk to anyone, or do you need to, like, expend this energy somehow?
You know what? I finally got my voice back.
Yeah.
I haven't been talking all Juno week, so I'm probably going to do some talking this time.
Oh, yeah, because now you can...
Now I can relax, enjoy, I can talk, and not act like I'm a diva.
Yeah. So whatever... So you told me on the red carpet that Shawn Mendes gave you a bunch of sprays
and
stuff. So
what a nice guy.
That's amazing.
Like, the guy's incredible.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So, but now that he has helped you through this, you can go back to just screaming and doing whatever you want.
Exactly.
Awesome. Congratulations, man.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Enjoy your portrait.
Thanks. Yes,
I'll
thank
see you.
You
at the party.
All right. Yeah, sounds good. All right, see you guys.
It'd be great. Yeah. So we are, are we getting down to it right now?
We're getting down to the nitty gritty.
Is it like,
the nitty gritty.
What, is the show over? The show's over. I gotta.
So I think we're
done. Wait, we're getting Nenshi?
Oh, no, we are not done.
So are you not going to draw one for him? Okay, good.
We are not done. We
guys,
are not
if you should get,
done.
So I did, I have a tweet from Christy Lay saying I should get Mariana's Trench backstage at the Junos.
The you pillow.
Know? Yeah, the pillow got some paint on it. At Christy Lay said I should get Mariana's Trench back at the Junos. We talked to Josh.
That was great.
Pretty early in the show. He was amazing.
That was great.
It was a really good conversation. So if you're watching on YouTube, you can rewind the stream.
Actually, go back and watch
Facebook,
it if you want right now.
Yeah. So you can.
Or you can just stay live with us.
You can rewind that and watch that. And my sister, who is watching, realized that Chad Kroger talked on camera about our family's Jenga game. So I didn't really think about that, but that's the thing that happened. So shout out to the Sutherlands. And our new Chad Kroger Connect via Jenga. So I believe our last, probably our last, knowing that the show is wrapped, is going to be Mayor Nenshi of Calgary. And Mayor Ron Sinovato. Oh, yeah, so passing the baton. I love it. Yeah.
Oh, that's great.
Hey, guys. Ryan.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing great. How are you doing? Yeah, come on in.
Are we playing Jenga? Is that what's happening?
Well, there was some children playing Jenga earlier. I've had this thing out. There's
no, wrong mic.
There's one.
I'm fired.
There's another one.
It was good. There we
Live
go.
Live TV. It's awesome.
It's all happening, right? So, yeah, no one touched the Jenga for hours, and then two kids came, walk off the earth, had their kids with them, and they were just like, dumped it out. It was great. It was like, that's why it's here.
There's Trivial Pursuit there, too. I used to be a champion at Trivial Pursuit. Let's not even try.
I'm not shocked. Okay. I don't want to waste too much of your time with Trivial Pursuit. The handoff is happening here. Calgary has been such an amazing host city. Everyone's so excited to have it in Ottawa next year. What has it meant for you to have this event here? And what are you particularly excited about, for 2017?
Well, you know, it's been huge for us to have it here as part of our year of music. Mm-hmm. Where people are just thinking about creativity and innovation in music. And I see a great Calgary artist, Mandy Stobo, over there doing visual art. Hey, Mandy. So it's all been about creativity and And these economic times, really having people think of Calgary as a place where innovation and creativity happens. Next year, I understand there is some big party going on in Ottawa, and the Junos will be part of that.
Absolutely. Of course, Canada turns 150 years old. And
sesquicentennial, a word that I've learned because of
sesquicentennial,
that.
Sesquicentennial, yeah.
I love saying it. I say it all the time now.
Me too.
So we've got a great lineup of activities that we're planning for the whole year, mm-hmm. the Junos being one of the great highlights because we're very, very proud, obviously, of the Canadian music scene, mm-hmm. and some great Ottawa great Canadian artists coming from Ottawa. Alanis Morissette, sure. Bruce Coburn, Paul Anka, the classic Paul Anka. Brian Adams lived in Ottawa for a couple of years. So
I think Vancouver claims him, though.
Yeah, that's true. But we're very excited about hosting. Nahid and his team have done a great job in Calgary. They've set the bar very high. But we've got a really good local organizing committee. We're out here to learn, and we're looking forward to hosting people this time next year at the Canadian Tire Centre and having a week-long celebration all over the city of Ottawa.
I'm sure it's going to be amazing. Calgary has been so fantastic to everyone in our whole team. Cannot wait for Ottawa next year. Thank you so much for your time, guys.
Really appreciate it. Thank you.
See you in 2017.
Thank you.
And Mandy has been doing portraits, as you know.
Hey, Mandy.
A new bad portrait. How are you doing?
So apparently Mayor Ninji has like 8 bad portraits. So guys, up next we're going to have the tenors, and I suspect that we are winding down just by virtue of the fact that, you know, the main show is, you know, currently over. Someone just blinked 5 minutes in my face, but I don't know what it was a countdown to be totally honest. Tenors. Okay, there we go. Guys, let's take a moment to thank the City of Calgary. Tourism Calgary, of course, has been very generous to so many of us, including, oh.
Hey, buddy, where are we?
How's it going? Come on in. How's it going?
Good, man.
Good to see you. Sit down, grab a microphone.
There's a few of us now.
Yeah, that's fair. We've had.
We're playing Jenga?
Yeah, we got wild with the Jenga. There were some kids. People got crazy.
All right.
What was your guys' like favorite game growing up?
Well, this was definitely one of them.
Jenga was up there?
Yeah, it was Connect Four.
Oh, okay. Oh.
What was
a good name?
What was that duck one?
As far as something a little more cerebral, Balderdash. Remember that?
Oh, Balderdash is good.
That was pretty good. Yeah. For me, I like Bright Light. Remember those little things? You put the little things in, you create the designs.
Yeah.
All those nice colors.
That's a real, like, cerebral loner kind of answer.
Where you nailed him! You nailed it!
Exactly
like,
who I am. Yeah. You just
no,
nailed
like,
me.
You're
perfectly.
Really, like, I appreciate that. Someone has to be the bright light one, right?
That's
like,
right, yeah.
I liked playing Doctor. That was fun when you can't mess up or hit the sides, remember?
Okay,
Operation.
What you're describing as Operation, playing Doctor.
Oh, wait, I still play Doctor. I still role play. This is going down.
Okay, end of the night.
There you go.
We're just talking about exploration. It's real fun. How's your guys' Juno's been? How's this night been for you? Yeah?
Juno's been awesome. Like just hanging out with the other artists and being here and singing, you know, the tribute to Burton. You know, we feel so honored and blessed to be here, honestly, and to be Canadian. You know, we're so proud. Like, Canada's just a melting pot.
Oh my God! It's Shauna!
Handsome devil, come here, squeeze in.
This guy was gonna play hockey. He's a good hockey player. This guy.
This guy's handsome.
I don't want to steal your time, but I just want to say
steal it.
How nice these guys are. I had no voice the other day, and Fraser over here came to my room, and he's gave me all these remedies.
Oil oregano. Shout out oil of oregano. That's good. Yeah.
Beehive spray.
That will mess you up.
It's amazing. You're a resilient man. Like you had nothing the other day, and you came out and you killed it today, man.
Thank you.
And twice. Twice.
Oil oregano, man.
You're
tenors,
amazing.
You guys got my back. But anyways, Sean, I'm gonna let you get on with
his album.
What's your favorite game?
Hockey, man.
Yeah.
There you go. That's the good Canadian.
Not
answer,
solitaire. Good to see you, man.
Awesome, brother. Take care.
Sean Hook.
We asked
at Sean Hook.
That was like a smooth answer earlier. We pulled out the Trivial Pursuit for a second when Nickelback was here, and one of the questions was like, which country has the most coastline? And the answer was Canada. And we were like, oh my God. Huge batch of questions, we found.
Oh, let's do some questions.
Yeah.
How long did that take?
I know. It's a lot.
Oh,
it was
my goodness.
A lot of stage.
I remember those.
So that was like a really nice grabbing Sean Hook moment. Who's been your favorite artist to maybe get a chance to connect with that you weren't friends with before?
Oh, man. Geez, so many.
Like, that we didn't get to work for?
Oh, just that you were like, oh, a new friend. Now I'm best friends with Tom Cochran.
Tom Cochran is the dude. He's so awesome, so nice.
Yeah.
And a lot of fun. Jim Cuddy.
Yeah.
As well.
Yeah,
I gotta tell you a story. So before we went on, I had to go to the bathroom really bad, and I literally had like 10 minutes to like go to the bathroom, do whatever, vocal warm up, and in the bathroom, and someone bangs on the door, and they're like, security, that's not allowed. You have 30 seconds. I'm like, oh my God, I'm in someone's bathroom. I get outside and it's Shawn Mendes going, ha ha, got you, buddy. Were you worried? Were you sketching out? Funniest guy ever, man. He's very down to earth and he terrified me while I was in the bathroom.
That is awesome. Can I share a Tom Cochran story with you
shortly? Please.
So Tom Cochran, Jim Cuddy, and Devin Cuddy were walking the red carpet together, right? At some point, Jim Cuddy, I guess, kind of got like stuck behind chatting with someone, so Tom and Devin end up outside, and Devin kind of looks around and can't see his dad, and then just goes to Tom. You guys performed. Like, when you were asked, I mean, what an honor. I got to meet him earlier, and I was like, you never think you're going to be, like, looking Burton Cummings in the eyes talking to him, right?
Yeah. Well, you know, we watched a lot of the videos and stuff, and, you know, we heard those songs growing up as well, some of us anyway.
Yeah.
And we just wanted to pay tribute to that era and, you know, to make it as authentic as possible and to respect the music that he's made. You know, it's an amazing songwriter, a Canadian icon, you know, known all over the world.
Yeah.
And it was such an honor for us to do it. You know?
That's amazing. Well, guys, I'm going to let you, you know, get to your parties and go, you know, enjoy the rest of the night. We are early stages because there are so many of you.
Early stages.
Beautiful portrait of you, but Mandy.
Oh.
Mandy, we love you.
Did you get my big nose? Did you get my big nose?
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's amazing.
Was that done in like 5 seconds? Like, what the
heck? Hey,
that
was amazing.
Products look a little more like that. So that's John Montgomery, host of the Juno. Wow.
Handsome.
Awesome.
Handsome.
And you had four to deal with us. Like,
yeah.
So she's whipping through.
That's awesome.
So I assume you guys are going to be around.
Can we do a couple shout-outs?
Yeah, oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah, we want to thank Style by Kim XO. She killed it on the outfits tonight. House of Dalla and Armani, thank you so much. Jeffrey Latimer, our manager, it's been amazing, and Universal's been incredible.
I got to mention Lily Put Hats because, you know,
Is a really good hat.
Yeah.
What's it made of? Amazing products.
Hey, you know what? I'm wearing vegan tonight, man. So I'm all good.
Remy's. I want to give a shout out to all the vegans
all
out
the
there.
Vegans
Remy's
there,
representing,
vegan, there you go.
And all the super athletes. Fraser representing them.
Yeah,
that's right. And all the awkward dancers. I'm giving us a shout out.
There you go.
We love you guys.
You guys can go deeper for a second if you want, because she can finish her painting if you guys want to keep showing her stuff.
You mean
I had a crush on my cousin when I was younger.
Story.
Totally awkward.
Mike's got a story.
So Fraser, I met you in an airport once. Yes. We, you had a guitar with you, I think. Yes, and we reminisced because we, maybe it was. Wow, now we know.
Yeah.
Now we know. Fraser goes to the. No, I'm not gonna say that. Never mind. There we both.
We can't cut this.
Awkward.
In LA.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. This is like, do you remember me now?
Yes, brother.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Dig it.
I think they're gonna stay and have a conversation.
No, but we both.
We're just gonna go.
Awesome,
I love it.
Yeah.
I'm excited about the portrait. I can't wait.
That is awesome.
Can you give me like extra chiseled cheekbones?
Can you do Photoshop for Clifton,
please?
All right. I had a mustache in mind, and I was like, "That's not right. That's not like how I look." But to be honest, I was like, "Maybe I should grow a mustache." Like that's pretty great. So, if you guys could compose a tribute to any other, great Canadian artist, having now done one, like who as a group, you know, because I imagine there's a lot of different tastes, you know, between you guys.
Yes, very
but
eclectic.
Is there anything else that really sort of ties you guys together, where you're like, "Yes, this one would be something that we would love to do too."
I'd have to say Leonard Cohen. I mean, we started with his Hallelujah. It was a song that meant a lot to us because it was our appearance on Oprah Winfrey, and we sang that song, and it kind of catapulted us a bit. And you know, he's just an awesome writer, poet. And a beautiful human being.
You
so
guys met him,
that
right?
yeah.
Oh, you guys met?
Yeah, no, for sure. Clifton and I.
Yeah, and he speaks a language that very few understand. He was so artistic and poetic. Just having a conversation with him was like listening to poetry.
You needed
amazing.
Cole's notes.
He was for sure like a bright light as a favorite game as a child.
Oh, did he?
Guy, really? Sure.
Oh, well, there you go. Maybe that's where I get my wisdom.
Yeah, exactly. Well, what was that? So, what was it like to meet him? I mean, what was because I mean, obviously, you know, that song being such an important part.
It was
of
very
you
cool
guys, right?
Because you always have in your head, okay, well, he might not want to talk to us or have the time to, but he was so humble, you know, and he
liked our version.
Yes.
Which was such a relief because there was a moratorium out on Hallelujah because many people were doing it. But when he talked to us, he's like,
boys, I heard your version is beautiful. And we were just like, okay.
He probably never says that, too. Like, that's huge.
Yeah, pretty awesome. Yeah, pretty awesome. Very moved, so
he never says that to
you,
us.
Leonard.
I mean, he has always been open, because he said that about, like, the Jeff Buckley version. I feel like he's an open-minded guy. Like, he's not too precious about, his things. His talent is really as a songwriter.
Yeah. Well, I mean, as a poet, I mean, you can't be too precious with, what you're saying. I mean, you got to just put it out there, so.
Awesome. All right, well, I'm going to let you guys sort of get on to the rest of your Juno Sunday night.
Thanks, Canada. TFFs, we love you guys. TFFs in the house, we know you're watching. We love you guys.
Awesome.
Love you, Canada.
Thank you, brother. Thank you. Make love, not war, brother.
Okay, guys, so I do think we have Alicia Cara coming up soon. Ho, ho, ho!
Guys. It's been an exciting night!
Okay, so guys, people are asking for Sean. Call Sean. Again, as we know, hold on, I'm attached to you here. I am quite attached to you, actually, Mike.
Yeah, we're attached.
I'm very attached to you.
Emotionally.
Yeah, so we do have Alicia Cara next. So, guys, if you are an Alicia Cara fan, let us know questions on Facebook. If you're on Facebook, and Rebecca, just yell them at me. We'll ping them at me. We're going to be on YouTube. So get in the comments there. Let us know. Or you can tweet me. Or you can tweet Mike. We'll try to get your questions in. But again, guys, Shawn Mendes, we can only get if we get Stephen Harper. That's just like Juno law now, unfortunately.
Unfortunately.
I'm sorry to say. It's just you gotta have rules. You got to have rules. So people are asking for Avril. We did, when I saw Avril, I was like, this is crazy. What else? Mariana's Trench. Yeah, if you guys missed it, we talked to Josh earlier, and he was great. He did like this amazing operatic singing. We talked a lot about his dad's studio that he used to have. And you can rewind on the stream and watch that interview.
Rewind it up. We got up next,
enjoy
man.
The future. Yeah, great. Just tell me. But yeah, so if you guys have Alicia Cara questions, let them know. She opened the show. It sounded fantastic from over here. But to be honest, it's going to be tomorrow before I'm actually able to experience or enjoy any of this myself. But you know, I bet it was all really good.
Oh yeah.
You know who I could have talked to more?
Who?
Nenshi. I love Nenshi. And you know, that's what I love about Nenshi is like, Nenshi doesn't just like Nenshi knows your full name, Mandy. Like, he like, that guy totally cares about the people in the city and, like, the art that they're making and stuff, right? It's truly incredible.
So cool, man.
And of course, Mayor Watson from Ottawa, super excited to be in Ottawa next year for the Junos, and also a great mayor.
Yeah.
I'm honestly less familiar with Mayor Watson. I mean, but I'm sure...
I'm sure he's a great mayor.
He's a super good mayor. So, Alicia Cara, for those of you who weren't watching earlier, she performed first. She won Breakthrough Artist of the Year, which... And we don't have to tell you, it's been a huge year for you. Are you an Alicia Cara fan?
I am.
Imagine if you said actually, no just then.
No.
A no guy. I'm going to leave.
Actually, I saw her first on the Tonight Show. I think it was her first appearance in the U.S. And so that's how actually I found out about her.
Yeah.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah, no, she... and she just, like... popped internationally in such a like huge way, like you just like could not miss it there for a minute. Like it was just like,
yeah,
it was crazy. Yeah. It got like so rowdy back here. Right?
It is. It's pretty rowdy.
I think like
you guys can't tell how rowdy it is.
Yeah. So like the show let out. The show finished, I guess, 15, 20 minutes ago maybe, and then everyone flooded out here.
And it's rowdy.
Yeah. Come on in.
Come in.
How's it going?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Hi, how are you doing?
How are you? Good,
congrats.
How are you? Thank you so much.
Here's a microphone for you.
Thank you so much.
You can shove over.
Yeah.
Nice. So this is really comfortable, you guys.
It has to be because we've been back here for like ever.
Hours. I can feel the seat is very warm. It's good. You've kept
like
it warm.
I'm worried. You're the first one who's acknowledged it, but I'm always like, can you get weird people out when they sit down? They're like, it's not just warm, it's hot.
No, it's actually, it's nice. It gives me a nice little, you know.
I mean, you would pay a lot of money for heated seats in a car.
Absolutely.
So we're just trying to provide you that luxury seating experience.
Thank you so much. It's really nice.
It's actually very expensive. Catherine from Cares is going to collect money from
you. Okay. I knew it. Should I just move here?
Maybe move over. Congratulations on your win.
Thank you so much.
And congratulations on opening the show. I mean, this is a big night.
Yeah, many things.
I know. So how are you feeling right now? Like, do you feel like a few people have kind of described this sensation as either being like, I feel nothing because it's just like all happening.
That's me.
Yeah, so that's you?
Absolutely. It's hard to feel something when it just, like my body's here right now, but my head is like in the clouds, somewhere on cloud 9 or 10 or 11. And I just like, I mean, that's not to say that I'm not happy. Like, of course, I'm happy and ecstatic, yeah. But it just doesn't feel real. So it's hard to feel anything. You know what I mean? It's very strange, really strange feeling.
I think it's, like, hard to contextualize. Like, I don't know what it would be like to win a Juno and open the Junos. Like, I can't even imagine.
Yeah, I don't even know what it's like because I don't feel it.
Like, when I get this morning I got breakfast, like, after the hotel was supposed to stop serving breakfast, and I was like, this is the best day of my life.
Of your life, absolutely.
So I can't imagine what something that's, like, actually good.
That's actually really good. Never mind. That's a close second.
They're going to give you two kinds of meat instead of just one.
See, that's a close second, definitely.
It was pretty good. We talked to you on the red carpet, and you were, like, pretty amped, pretty wired about opening the show. What was your kind of first thought when you walked out there?
Oh, my goodness. It's just like there's a lot of people here.
Yeah.
And not only were there a lot of people there, but then my next thought was, wow, there's going to be a lot of people watching this. It's not just the people here, like the thousands of people here. It's going to be the millions that are watching on TV, which was very scary. But then I saw my parents, and they were all like, yeah, and it was good.
What was your first live TV experience? Because I think for some artists this is like new, but you have, you know, had the, you've been down in the States, you've done some bigger shows. What for you was the first live show you ever did?
First live show. Well, my first, not my first, like, kind of live show was Jimmy Fallon, but that's like pre-recorded by like an hour. So that,
but it's live to tape, right?
It's still live to tape, absolutely. Yeah. So that was terrifying but amazing. I'm such a huge fan of Jimmy. And then I think I did. It was another award show. Am I allowed to mention another award show on here?
Yeah, it's fine.
It was the Streamy Awards, which was really
I mean,
cool.
They're not as good.
No, it's all about the Junos. But, come on, this is Canadian stuff.
It's fair. Now, we've got Mandy over here, who's a local artist from Calgary. She runs a Twitter account called @BadPortraits, and she's been doing bad portraits.
Oh, that's amazing. That's actually really good,
though. No, they're not bad at all. Like, that's everyone's reaction.
Oh, my gosh, that's so cool.
And so this is a portrait that she literally did when you started sitting down.
Oh, my gosh, that's incredible. That's not a bad portrait.
No.
I wish I could, if this, like, this is like my best portrait, probably. This is incredible. Thank you.
They're pretty great. So that's yours to keep.
Thank you
There's
so much.
Envelopes, you can give it to, like, you know, your manager or something.
So absolutely. No, I'm going to keep this.
You don't have to, like, carry it around.
No, I'm probably going to keep it. Show it off.
Yeah. So they're pretty great. So what are you going to do now? What are you going to do to unwind? How's your night going to end now?
Honestly, I wish I had something cool to say. Probably just, like, eat something and then sleep and reflect.
What are you going to eat?
Check Twitter. What am I going to eat? That's a good... I didn't think that through.
No, you got to think that through.
Probably lots of junk food. I think I earned it tonight, right?
Yes.
Some sort of junk food. Yeah, of some sort.
I got to let you go. What's your favorite junk food?
I love, like, French fries.
That's
French
good.
Fries are my go-to.
Cool. Shout out French fries.
Shout
congratulations.
Out to French fries. Thank you so much.
Brampton. What's up, Brampton?
B-Town. Oh, yeah. Hey, B-Town. Yeah, shout out to Brampton. I love you guys. This is my home.
Let's take a moment, to talk about just the glory that is Brampton.
The glory that is B-Town.
Thank you for everything, Brampton.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you guys so much.
Yeah, cheers.
Appreciate it. Thank you, too. Thank you. I think I kept the seat warm.
Oh, that's good. Okay. Yes. Thank you very much. I'm so glad that we haven't cooled anything off too much. Oh, so guys.
That's cool.
That was great.
Who do you got next, man?
I don't know. I don't know what's happening. I'm going to...
You got water.
We got water.
I'm so jealous of your water. I absolutely can.
So, guys, we have Dean Brody followed by Burton Cummings coming up next. Dean Brody, of course, won Country Album of the Year. Burton Cummings inducted into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame, which now is a new home at Studio Bell, home of the National Music Center, which is a beautiful new building in downtown Calgary, which I had a chance to visit. You haven't had a chance to go there yet, right?
No.
It's insane.
Next time.
Yeah, no, it's totally worth it. It's a beautiful, beautiful building. Like, honestly, sort of like unparalleled. Just like all these weird tiles. They have this like insane collection of old keyboards and synthesizers and stuff. It's like,
wow.
It's extremely sick.
Pretty amazing.
This is honestly like such a mess. Like, what we look, just what do people think of us? It's terrible.
You know what that means? It's been a better night than last night. Because it's more of a mess.
It seems more lived in, that's for sure.
For sure. Oh, that's all good. You can mess it up.
Ah, nice hat.
Shout out to my man, Justin Broadband, for making all the merchandise for the Junos. Look at this.
These are nice hats, man.
Aren't they?
I love a
it
fresh hat.
It says with glowing hearts, they'll represent Canada and represent my homeboy, Justin Broadman, and me, all this stuff.
That's awesome, man. Yeah, I saw those on the Junos website. Cool. So if you have any questions for Dean Brody, throw them in the chat box on your streaming platform of choice or tweet them at us. How are the Facebook peoples doing? So Carol is down. I love it. Okay, that's great. That's still kind of cool. Yeah, honestly, it's great. So when we did this last night during the gala, well, thank you so much. When we did this last night during the gala, this was like 4 hours straight, and I was honestly terrified that I would have to use the bathroom. So I didn't drink any water for like 8 hours. And by the end of it, I think like my body was just sort of straight cannibalizing itself. What is? There's like no camera on you either. Mike's just doing some real killer posing, which is extremely good. I saw them, man. They looked good. Just got two waters. Oh, here we go. Come on in, man. Come hang.
Oh. Jenga.
How's it going? Congratulations, man.
Thanks, man.
Here, grab a mic.
All right.
Oh, other. Okay, hold on. I got to move over to the other side of you.
Okay.
Yeah. Here we go. Here. Oh, there it is. Yep. How's that? We looking cool now? Yeah, we look good now, I think.
We're good, okay.
Yeah. So congratulations on your win, man.
Thanks, man. Yeah.
That's
good.
That's a big one. So we were talking to Just Rain, who actually presented the Country Award tonight. And he said that, I didn't realize this because we weren't in the room, but it was like swiping was the action instead of like an envelope or whatever.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I know. It was like, I don't know.
On an iPad or what?
Yeah, I don't know. He said it was on a phone. It sounded like it was a really like future terror kind of stuff.
That sounds like stuff that could go really wrong.
That's what I'm thinking, right?
Like cyber terrorism.
That's what my biggest concern at the Junos in 2016 is cyber terrorism.
Yeah, man. Justin Bieber, he could win the Country Album of the Year.
That's what I'm saying, yeah.
Some of these, if Anonymous gets into that stuff.
Yeah, that's if 4chan gets involved, like we got concerns, my friend.
We'll have troubles.
I know. So how's your night been?
It's been good. Yeah. Winning the Country Album of the Year was amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, who's your runner up? Because you obviously want to pick your own album, but what's your second favorite album in that category?
Yeah, I think High Valley. They had a great bunch of songs on that record. And a good bunch of guys. Really, lots of energy in their music. Thoughtful music.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, probably High Valley for sure.
Awesome. It seems like and correct me if I'm wrong here, but that Canada has been a bit slower to just sort of embrace. I mean, there's obviously a strong tradition of country music here, you know, like Hank Snow and, you know, on and on and on. But that, you know, contemporary country music, while it's sort of surged in popularity, dominant radio format in the States, hasn't been the same thing in Canada. But that's really changed in the last couple of years.
I think it really has, man. Like,
is that fair?
It's really, yeah, it's totally fair. It's really caught on fire. Like, it's one of the biggest genres in radio and festivals. You think of summer festivals and the kind of numbers that are showing up to those festivals. And it's a lot of young folks are coming out to these. They're passionate about country music. It's right up there. It's one of the top genres in the country, in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in the U.S., you're right. It's like probably the number one format.
I think, yeah.
But it's getting close in Canada, too.
Well, it's interesting. Like, I'm from Toronto, and now, in the last 2 years, we've had, like, two country bars open up, and Boots and Hearts, which is just down the highway, is huge.
It's humongous, yeah.
Yeah, and you really see that, like, changing. But still, I mean, I don't think there's really a country music station in Toronto at this point.
Yeah, there's outliers, for sure.
Yeah.
Right? There's Hamilton's got a station. And,
yeah.
KX96 and stuff, so there definitely is. There is a country base there, but yeah, downtown Toronto.
I know, resistant.
Yeah.
But do you see that changing? Like, do you see that sort of slow wave kind of coming in?
I don't know, man. Like, I know when I'm downtown Toronto, I feel like Anonymous.
Yeah.
Which is awesome.
Yeah.
It's kind of cool. But yeah, I think as music changes, I don't know if it's the iTunes world where the genres are kind of all kind of meshing now. I think it's changing quickly.
What's the city that you are the least anonymous in Canada? Like, what city can you not just, like, go to a Shoppers in and, like, pick up some rice cakes?
Yeah, wow. Probably my hometown. The closest city to my hometown is Cranbrook.
Yeah.
I probably have trouble there.
And that's not
Halifax,
yet. Tough to maybe just, like, go get a drink at a bar and, like, relax in Halifax. Yeah.
And I do love to be anonymous. Although the more downtown, the more metro I go, I'm safer. But if I'm on the suburbs and I go to a bar in the suburbs, it's different. Right?
That's like a weird sort of great irony. I know, it's kind of nice though, right? You can just like
it's kinda cool,
hit up whatever you.
Or if I go to an Indian restaurant with my wife, I'm fine.
Yeah,
it's
no problem, right? I've always like I remember doing an interview a while back with George Pettit, who's a singer of this band Alexis on Fire, who were very big in Canada for a while. But he always described his level of fame as being such that, like, when he goes to, like, Olive Garden for dinner or, like, Eastside Mario's with his wife, that, like, a chef will come out and be like, I bought you a shot. And he's like, it's perfect.
Oh, yeah.
It's, like, exactly kind of what he wants. Like, what is your sort of dream level of recognition? Because it's nice to have people come up and be like, hey, I like what you do. But you want to be able to live your life.
For me, it's anonymity.
Yeah.
Yeah, strangely enough, like, I love being anonymous. And my wife and I live in this little fishing town right now that we know some locals, and but nobody else really kind of knows we're there, and we love it. I love being anonymous, man.
Yeah.
It's really special.
What led you to that town in particular? Like, what was the...
We moved there after my asked out of my record deal in Nashville. Things were getting really, really squirrely, and I had to move out of the country within, like, a week, and so I asked my wife, which town do you want to move to? And she said, well, I found this on Kijiji. We could move to this town, and a week later, I moved out there, and we love it. We love the people there. The fishing community, it's just really down-home, blue-collar kind of place. And it's kind of that's how I was brought up, so I feel very at home there.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah.
So we have Mandy over here. She runs at Bad Portraits on Twitter, and she has been doing paintings of all of our guests as I've been coming in and being interviewed. So
that's really cool.
So that is you, and she just started doing that when you showed up.
Wow. That's amazing. Mandy?
Yeah, Mandy. Yeah, yeah.
Amazing. Yeah, I look a little bit like Brad Paisley, I gotta say. You know Brad Paisley? Wow. This is really cool. That's amazing. My son is actually really into art, Pokemon art. He's really good.
Nice.
Yeah. No, this is really wonderful.
Awesome, man. Well, that is yours to keep. There's some envelopes over there, so feel free to grab one and
definitely will.
And show it off to your kid.
Okay.
Be like, one day, translate your Pokemon skill into doing paintings of artists at the Junos.
Yeah.
Living the dream.
Pokemon paintings, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Beautiful Pokemon. I've Pokemonified. Yeah. Thank you so much for your time, and congratulations on the win, man.
All right. Thanks a lot, man.
Yeah.
Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, of course. Okay. Cheers, man.
Yeah, come on.
What a... It's so good.
It's so good.
It's awesome. It looks great, man. Yeah. Thank you so much for your time, man. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, cheers. All right, guys, so we are winding down. I'm going to say, I know, but sometimes I got to stretch my legs, man. No, I know. I understand that when I stand, I'm not in the frame anymore, though, and that's obviously a problem. It's just a nice big crotch shot. You're welcome, everyone. How's the chat going over there? Should we take a look at the chat, or is it just people screaming at us about Shawn Mendes?
There's lots of Mendes going on.
Okay. If you have a take that is unrelated to Mendes in our dying moments, feel free to tweet it at us. It's like the least noisy and therefore kind of the easiest to kind of cut through on.
How you feeling, man?
I feel great.
Everyone here and in the back there, let's give Sam a round of applause.
I gotta say, nothing has made me feel worse than that moment.
Honestly, I have no idea how you do it.
That was for sure the saddest moment of my life right then. That's what you just saw.
You have quite the gift, sir.
You have quite the gift, my friend.
Well, my gift is not your gift.
Everyone gets different takes. So hold on. I'm just trying to see what else we got. So my sister is tweeting that my mom is saying that my mic is too low. But, like, of course you want to hear me more. And I've also... Yeah, just turn up... The suggestion to my mom was just to turn up the volume on her computer. Any other good things? Christy Lay, who was tweeting earlier about Marianne's Trench, was asking if we will post the awards later. I think so. The performances will all be available for streaming on Google Play Music. And there'll probably be individual... Hey, Catherine. Will any of the, like, award show be posted later on YouTube? Any of the award show itself? Is any of that going to end up on the channel? Cool. So all the performances that you missed? Yeah. Oh.
Oh, you're such a rebel.
This is true transgression. People have been behaving so fine all night. There's a green line of tape behind our cameras that says, do not stand, and a woman just stood defiantly on it. But otherwise, people have been very well behaved.
Minus those guys at the beginning.
No, minus those Hojo freaks at the beginning.
I love that you called them that.
So, no, I did say Google Play before you came back. But yeah, so if you're looking to watch or hear these performances, they're going to be on Juno TV, the YouTube channel. They're going to be on Google Play Music.
Google Play.
And we should also thank the OMDC and also thank the City of Calgary, who are such great hosts. It was so amazing to have Nenshi here. I gotta say, I think actually the most nervous I was for any of those interviews was Minister Jolie, because like musicians, I'm like over, but I'm like, yo, you're an elected representative in our federal government, and you have a very important job.
Yeah.
I'm shaking. Hey, it's Jill. Jill, you want to come talk
come
about how the show's gone? Come and sit down.
In, Jill.
Come and sit down. Jill.
She's been our fearless.
Not that exciting.
So this is Jill. Jill produces the show, produces Juno TV. When you're watching, great Juno TV features such as me
That's
interviewing
better.
Marianas
That's
Trench,
way better.
Or me playing games with.
Like a local group called Static. We're just talking to Jill.
Yeah, we're talking to Jill, Mandy. Come.
You should probably talk to
Oh, no, it's fine. It's fine. You're kind of like, you're over there. It's different than when we were in a room and we could all hear each other, right? So Jill is responsible for all of this. Jill, how's the night gone, in your opinion? How would you rate our performances?
Like a 6?
I mean, a 6 is good. That's a pass.
I'm happy with a 6.
A 6 is absolutely a pass. Yeah. I'd say that was good.
No, you guys did amazing.
So like an 8?
I'd say a 10.
I knew it. I felt like a 10. It felt like a 10 as it was coming out of my mouth.
When she said, "I'm a 10."
That
means she was lying.
That's the lying register.
It's a 10.
Known lying register.
It's a 10.
What's been so, like, I was just describing that having Heritage Minister Melanie Jolie on was like sort of the most nervous that I actually was.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
Otherwise I'm like, you know, like Alicia Carr is more famous, but I'm like, you're a musician. I've done this
You're
for
good.
A minute, yeah. Who were you the most excited about over the last 2 days?
I don't know. I was pretty excited about Nickelback.
Honestly, Nickelback were really fun, guys. Like,
yeah.
Nickelback are down.
Yeah. They're really famous.
They're super famous, and this is part of what I was saying earlier. They're so tall.
Yeah.
Like, as a group of men, they're big, strong men. Super strong men.
Yep.
So that was like, I was thoroughly charmed, to be honest.
Opposite of me. And
yeah, they are. And me too. Like, I mean,
yeah.
I'm like a little
you're,
like
you're,
thicker
you're,
than
you're
you.
A little thick, but
yeah.
I am small.
I lift.
Tiny.
I lift.
And.
Yeah.
Adorable.
You're petite.
Oh,
you're a petite man.
But I'm very petite.
No, they are big. They were really. And then later on when Chad was chirping at Sean Hook, that was fun.
Yeah.
So Nickelback was a highlight
that
for you?
That was my highlight, yeah. I mean, yeah, for sure.
How do you think this compares to previous years? Like, what is your...
Amazing. You guys rocked it. It was
but, like, honestly, like,
honestly.
This is the third year you guys have done this, right?
Yeah.
What mistake did you notice this year that you'll want to correct in 2017?
Well, the mistake from last year was the lulls. We had a lot of lulls waiting on winners.
Right.
So now you guys did all this crazy stuff.
Well, yeah, there were babies here playing with Jenga.
Babies.
We ended up, like, not using this at all. We asked... Cardi a mind trap question.
Yeah, that
we
went,
asked
that went over horribly.
We but he's fun.
Yeah.
And then we asked two Trivial Pursuit questions of Nickelback, which is like I like it. Oh, you have a question for Jill.
Question
who is this question
Jill.
From? Okay, this question is from Danielle. Who is Jill's office crush? Asks Danielle Sanford. So Jill, it's time to come clean. On your, 2 minutes left on Facebook Live, by the way. So this answer
almost
is going to be basically how we end Facebook
left.
Live.
I'm going to go with Andreas Mendoza.
Oh, Andreas Mendoza is extremely crushable. He runs marketing for Karis. He is,
he
I saw him
money.
Actually.
That's how we all have jobs.
Yeah,
so.
Let's admit it. Money is the most crushable thing, guys.
1 minute left.
1 minute left. 1 minute left on Facebook. So thank you, Facebook. Thank you, everyone who watched on Facebook. We will continue to be live on JunoTV.ca. I assume to torture us, or is? Burton Cummings is still coming. Okay, so if you're watching on Facebook, maybe consider going to JunoTV.ca because we are going to be talking to Burton Cummings, who was entered into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame this year, part of the brand new opening of Studio Bell, home of the National Music Center, and he is the coolest man in the world. So that is going to be great. So any other comments on Facebook? Everyone just having a good time, being polite? Everyone on Facebook was so nice. They were like, when do we want lights? Or who do we want lights? When do we want her? Soon, please. And everyone on YouTube is like, "Dear Shawn Mendes, you dickwad." So much appreciated. Okay, bye, Facebook. Bye. All right. So, guys, now
bye.
We can talk
Bye-bye.
Shit on everyone on Facebook, right? Okay, bye, Jill. Oh, you need your phone. Okay. Who is Jill's office crush? I'm going to answer them. Andreas. Send. There we go. So, guys, if you have any questions for Burton Cummings, which are like, what is it like to be a legend, please let me know. Lexi St. Pierre is asking for more Marianas Trench. To be honest, guys, I think Marianas Trench have left the building to go and party like rock stars with cool shirts and pants. But if you are looking for me interviewing Marianas Trench, I did do that for Juno TV. So you can go on your YouTube to Juno TV. And if you look up Marianas Trench, there's a series of fantastic videos that where I was very charming and I interviewed them, and also where they performed live in the vault inside of the Kara's offices.
That sounds really cool.
It was super cool.
Shout out to YouTube right now.
Yeah.
Let me say that again because Margaret from YouTube wasn't listening. Okay, one more time.
Oh, yeah.
Guys,
they're trying to shut us down.
The light is shut.
Why are they? Why?
Real quick, shout out to YouTube. Shout out to YouTube, everyone. YouTube, we are streaming live on YouTube. That's the reason why you can see us right now is because of YouTube.
Yeah.
And YouTube.
Where can people watch you on YouTube if for some reason someone watching this is not familiar with you, Mike?
You can find me just by typing in my name.
Great. And you can find me, guys. Maybe by typing in my name, but I don't know. My channel is called This Exists. It's extremely good.
It's extremely good.
Yeah, I would go so far as to say it's the second best channel on YouTube. Of course, after Mike's channel.
I don't know about my channel, but Just Rain's channel is pretty good.
Just Rain's channel is awesome. He's amazing. What's your favorite YouTube channel?
I've been really digging. The name's escaping me right now. But I really like it.
That was like when we were on the red carpet, and I was like, oh, remember we chatted yesterday. Who was your favorite interview? And you were like, I loved Bob.
Last name just escaped me. And this is what happens to me. Hey, guys, I'm really good at doing music, and I'm really bad at remembering things.
Yeah, and we've also established that you are extremely bad at math. Math is not a strong suit for Mike.
I'm really good at video editing. I make videos. I can shoot videos.
Yeah.
I can sing a little, sort of. I can beatbox. I can record music.
Now you're bragging,
write
honestly.
Music, but I cannot remember things.
Oh, yeah.
I cannot do math. And I'm.
And you're small.
Okay, I'm tiny.
You're small.
I was actually, the weird thing about that, I was actually saying to my wife the other day, I'm like, I'm really glad I'm short.
Oh, that's bullcrap, man.
No, no, no. Listen to me real quick.
Yeah.
I'm really comfortable on airplanes. Last month,
that's true.
I've been on a lot of airplanes. I've been on 21 airplanes in the last month and a half. So
yeah,
I spent a lot of time on the airplane. So I'm really happy I'm short.
That's good. So we got AM Static, who are a local Calgary band. They were nominated for Electronic Album of the Year. We're going to have them come on.
Awesome.
My wife is also she's very short, and she like never thinks about a plane. Like our old house had like a really, really short ceiling in the basement. And she was like, oh, we can have house shows here. And I'm like, no, you can't. Everyone has to double over. But she just could like walk through and was like totally free. Come on in, guys. Come hang. Yeah, Game Boy Color, we got it all.
Oh,
hello,
yeah.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Hi,
hello.
Chris, this is my partner, Nils.
Awesome,
hey,
guys.
Hey, good to meet you.
Likewise.
Hey, congrats on the nom.
Can I just kick it here? With,
yeah, man. Oh, you're going to sit on the mic.
Pick that. Hold it up against your face.
Yeah.
I think that's how they work.
I mean, the pointy port sort of went right in the crevasse there for a second.
There's no snare in my headphones still.
No.
I think. I'm not sure why.
So, guys, I mean... congratulations on your nomination.
You got to take this Game Boy out of here if we're going to have an actual conversation.
It's fine. I mean, if one of you can play the Game Boy and one of you can at least kind of talk to me, that would be good.
What do we got in here? How good am I? Oh, yeah, I'm going to kill this.
Yeah. So just get into it.
Got it.
So has it been, so on one hand, so this is what I was thinking. I was like, A, it was probably great to be nominated for the Junos in a year when they're in your hometown.
Yes.
So an opportunity to show up the city. But B, it probably is unfortunate because you don't get to travel. Like, it's fun for me to be here because it's like I'm on vacation.
Sure.
But, like, you're just, like, at work.
Well, only depending on how you feel about travel.
Okay.
Sure. Well, at the same time, I'm a sound tech in the city, and I work right downtown. So I actually parked in the exact same spot at the exact same time that I do every week.
Yeah.
For the Junos.
So your life is, like, not changed at all this week.
Well, you know, I'm pretty regimented about my routine, and to have the Junos, like, not actually break my routine at all was
a dream.
The best best of all possible.
Yeah, because if these were in, like, you know, Montreal or something, and you had to, like, go to a different city where people don't always speak English, like, that would really throw you off your game, right?
Well, I, from the ages of 2 to 8, I actually lived in Montreal.
So you could handle it. But
I love it there, but at the same time, we're both fairly paranoid. We don't like leaving the house. And to gain recognition from Canada in a moment that also allowed us not to break our comfort bubble at all.
Yeah.
Was amazing.
It was a total dream, right?
Yeah.
That's great. What? Yeah. So have you guys had an opportunity to do much for Juno Week, go out and see anything? Like, what's this experience been like for you guys?
We were given the opportunity to play on Friday at Broken City, which was a great show.
Yeah, I love Broken City. Yeah, it's a great venue.
We unfortunately lost Milk and Bone due to the singer losing her voice.
Yeah.
But we got a chance to meet them, though, which was really nice.
They were so awesome. They were, yeah, we had them on last night on the stream, and she was like, I swear I don't normally sound like this. And I was like, it's a good tone. Yeah, I mean, whatever works.
Very, very sweet woman.
Yeah.
And, you know, we understand it.
Yeah.
Right? Every musician here understands it. Like, you're going to have to cancel a show every once in a while. If you can't sing and you're doing songs, it might be a
You can see where that, like, at some point could be a problem, right?
Yeah.
You're really excited about The Legend of Zelda, eh?
Yeah. Oh, huge.
We both are.
Oh, okay.
Actually, the guy who wrote the score for this, Koji Kondo, is one of our big inspirations.
Oh, okay. There we go. So this is like a theme. This is actually like sort of like a Nardwar gift almost,
actually,
right?
Where I'm
like,
really
is. I'm doing research right now. I'd love to get a government grant if possible for being here.
Okay. So Heritage Minister Melanie Jolie was here earlier.
Oh, my God.
So you should maybe like connect with her on that and like see if you can like get that grant. Be like, look, I know you guys are putting like billions of dollars into the arts, and I think you should give it to me specifically.
Yeah. Well, especially, can you perhaps give us some money to make some really, really sick music for video games?
Yeah.
We would love that.
That seems perfectly reasonable. Yeah. That's a good request, right?
Well, yeah.
There are so many video game manufacturers based out of Canada, and obviously based out of Montreal
right.
in particular, right? So it's got to be an opportunity, you know, like out there for the taking, right? You just got to go to Montreal and bang on the Ubisoft doors or whatever, right?
Yeah. And who is it? Subsidiary of BioWare or an offshoot?
Yeah.
What are they called? Who just re-released all of the old Dungeons & Dragons video games.
Oh.
Did, No, not Wizards of the Coast. That's for card games, right? Who did... move on.
Okay, so this was a comment for Am Static. We love your Juno Week live tweeting. Apparently your Juno Week live tweeting was extremely good.
Oh.
So that's
fantastic.
A nice, yeah.
We're happy to hear it.
This is the kind of stuff, these are the updates you're getting from your friends?
It's totally our mom's.
What was your mom has Catherine's phone number? That's
apparently, yeah.
Yeah, I love your tweets.
Your tweets are awesome.
I always like, I am blessed with extremely supportive and wonderful parents. Shout out wonderful and supportive parents. But it means like, sometimes like, because I don't like tweet or like do anything with like, an audience that includes my parents in mind, and so from time to time, like they'll be like, "I saw this on your Snapchat." Like that you were here. I was like, "Oh yeah, that's right." Like I always forget that it's like when you're live tweeting and living your life in public, that includes like basically having your parents with you all the time.
Yes.
Like it's which is great if you get along with your parents like I do.
Yeah,
sure.
I would say that we get along mainly with our parents. I'm also lucky enough, and I think Nils as well, to not have moms on Snapchat.
Oh yeah, my.
So or Facebook.
I think
I'm not even on Facebook anyways, so that makes it a lot.
Oh, so you're good. I think we made the mistake of recently, I was visiting with my folks, and we were talking a lot about Snapchat and like how because I think Snapchat is like really great, and then she was like, "Oh, I'll make an account." So she followed like you know myself and like my wife and everything. So now like you know when I'm, you know, 2 a.m. you know, like at some dumb bar,
yeah.
I'm like, and then the next day when I'm like, Mom, work's really stressful. Like, my life's really hard. And it's like, well, also I could just go to sleep sometimes.
Sure.
And she knows now.
Well, it's like giving a monkey a machine gun. You are like creating militant parents in a way by giving them access to social media.
Please don't call my mother a monkey again, please. No, it was a joke. I wasn't actually offended by it. They could see that you were like.
If he's joking, that means he's encouraging us to do it again.
Yeah, no, that's exactly.
I think that's how it works.
Yeah, I think so. Did your parents follow your Juno Week live tweeting? Like, do you know if they were like?
You know, I am sure that my mother is following this online and TV. That's all.
Yeah.
They just followed us. They kind of went old school with it.
Oh yeah.
Followed us physically.
Yeah, they were just like in a car across the street, like watching.
Doing
text messages.
Where like they have a bus behind, like where we're driving, and, like, signs out the window, and they're just cheering for
us. Oh, that's so nice. I mean, I always. The one thing that I like about the Junos, the one thing, is the only thing I like. One of the many things that I like about the Junos. No, dude, like, I haven't been drinking at all because I've had to, like, be back here being alert. Are they still serving? They're still serving? I'm good.
If you look around hard enough, I'm sure you're going to find
them. I know, I'm sure. Sorry, where was I going with this? Parents follow you. Oh, is that oftentimes people are like, oh, it's so great, I'm here, my parents are here. Like, a lot of times being a musician, especially if you're, you know, in a niche, you know, if you're not, you know, Mariana's Trench, you're not playing an arena, it can be hard to sort of contextualize it for parents unless, you know, they themselves were musicians. And so oftentimes I feel like you hear from artists who are like, when we got nominated for a Juno, it was finally like our parents were like, oh, I get it, because they've heard of the Junos. They kind of know what that stands for. Did this nomination sort of mean anything for your parents? Were they kind of, like, excited about it?
Yeah, you know, for sure. I think a definition of a success in our age group is when your parents don't understand what you do fully.
Yeah.
When they're like, I guess you can pay your bills, but I really don't understand what you do, and especially, like, even in music.
Yeah, but you're not asking me for money, so I guess it's fine.
Yeah. Yeah. So really, I think they're just proud and they're happy that we're not both still living at home.
Yeah. Then it's huge. Congratulations on all your success moving out of home.
Thank you.
And your nomination, I guess. That's something else.
Hopefully we'll not be back there in a year.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Guys, thank you. Your city has been a wonderful host. And congratulations on your nomination. Eh? It's been a pleasure.
So thank you.
Thank you for coming and hanging out. And then, this is bad. This is bad. So, okay, so you guys are old pals. Yeah.
Oh, that is it.
Are we done? We're done. Wrap. Show
thank
is over.
You so, much.
So we're not getting so thank all you. all the Shawn Mendes fans who are tweeting questions for Burton Cummings don't get to ask them is what you're saying. that is heartbreaking. I'm just gonna take a quick peek at my Twitter. Make sure that I'm not go ahead and say anything if you wanna.
Thank you to everyone who watched and everybody at Juno TV for having me involved. It was a good time. Had a lot of fun with my main man, Sam Sutherland here.
Megan Burns tweeted to me to ask, is it tough to go through so many interviews and does your throat hurt from talking so much?
It sounds like you're a little hoarse.
Yeah, for sure. It's dry in Calgary. It's a very dry climate. So yeah, my throat hurts, but it's not tough. It's wonderful to be able to hang out with Mike, to be able to hang out with Mandy, and to be able to talk to so many wonderful artists. I said this yesterday after we talked to Danuk Wajnaratne, who won Classical Album Composition of the Year, and we sort of ran into each other sort of in the bowels of the convention center afterwards, and he was like introducing me to his guest, and we were kind of chatting, and I was like, you know what it is? Especially with the people who had just won, it's like a legit honor to have an opportunity to talk to people like right after this big moment for them. So thank you so much to all the artists who came and chatted with us and shared the sort of immediate kind of post-moment excitement of winning a Juno with Mike and Mandy and I. It was an honor to be able to talk to all of you on what I think is a pretty special night for everybody.
Yeah, for sure.
So as Mike said, thank you so much to all the Juno TV crew, everyone at Karis. There's like 8,000, there's not 8,000, there's like seven. How many people are working on this right now?
Big shout out to the crew.
Everybody, can yeah, there's 10? Okay. So wait, should the crew come on and then we'll do like a pose and that'll be how we end, like a Breakfast Club style?
No, we're getting that.
Okay. So just know that there's about 10 hardworking people who have been setting up cameras, schlepping gear across the city, doing interviews, making this all run and making Mike and I look wicked cool and smat.
Thank
all
you.
Week.
Wicked smat.
So thank you so much to them for having us out. It's been an honor. I want to get Mandy's attention.
Would I be able to do that?
Hey, Mandy. Mandy's over it.
Mandy.
Mandy. We're just saying thank you to you. We're done. We're wrapping up.
Yeah, we're done.
Come on and sit down. Come on, sit down on the couch. So, there we go. So, yeah, Mandy, thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. This has been the best.
This was, like, honestly the most fun thing to just be able to throw to and everything. Like,
it was really fun.
Yeah.
I really wish that more people tonight had to take them around to all the parties.
I know, yeah.
I think that would have been fun, but yeah, no, it's been a great
I show. Think a lot of the people who got them tonight have, like, people who can carry them around for them, for sure. Like, Alicia Carr is not, like, stuffing all the goodies in her bag.
Just put it in my pocket.
Oh, man, I wish I had bigger pockets. I'm Alicia. Like, Alicia Carr never has to buy a dress or a pants with pockets again. That's what being famous means.
Yeah.
Well,
I guess we should wrap up.
On that note,
the point is thank you.
to everyone. This has been great.
This has been the best. And you guys are amazing.
Yeah.
You are amazing.
I think we should all.
We're all yeah. amazing.
Thank you to Calgary. Thank you to the OMDC. Thank you to all the Karis and Juno TV team. We'll be back in some capacity in Ottawa in 2017. Any other critical points for like the five people? And you guys can watch these performances on Juno TV and hear them on Google Play. So relive the magic. Take the magic home. Juno's 2016. We're good. We're good.